Houston, Texas, at BBVA Compass Stadium, this is Tiger Football.
The pageantry of homecoming is alive and well at Texas Southern University. We've ordered up a beautiful day in downtown Houston, and you can't beat a good homecoming parade. Good times for young and old alike. The fans will soon head inside BBVA Compass Stadium for some swag football. The 5-2 TSU Tigers host the 1-5 Arkansas Pine Bluff Golden Lions in a swag Western Division matchup. And hello, everyone. With Butch Alcindor, I'm Brett Dolan. Thanks for joining us here today. Butch, the Tigers coming off a loss on the road last week, but it feels like they have a lot to play for today.
They do. This is a very important game for the Tigers. And Coach Asbury, he's actually calling it a must-win game, because if the Tigers were to win this ball game, which we are hoping they will, they would have their first winning season since 2010, and that would be great for the entire program. And, of course, it is also homecoming, so it's a lot more fun to go to that homecoming dance with a victory than it is with a loss.
Yes, it is. Let's take a look at the SWAC standing starting in the Western Division. Tigers weren't able to enjoy a win last week, but you see the importance. They're trying to get that fourth conference win, and right now Grambling, they'll come in here next week. It could set up a big game.
Oh, it makes it really huge. If the Tigers win today, they're 4-2. You have Grambling coming in here. They have a chance to pick up some ground and move closer to the top.
Over in the Eastern Division, the pride of the division has to be Alcorn State. That was the team the Tigers played last week.
And they, you know, you wouldn't know it by the stats, but they were very, very close according to the stats. The Tigers just couldn't quite get it going in that game.
Tigers had a couple of quarterbacks that saw action last week on the road in Alcorn State, but they get their starter back this afternoon.
And they are extremely happy to have this guy back. Homer Causey, number 4, will be in the starting lineup. As you can see, he's only passed for 310 yards, but he only started one game, so he hasn't played much. He has played 3 games under his belt. He could have played last week. He's been dealing with a severe knee bruise, but they have extra padding for him, and so he wanted him to work with the receivers, get his timing down, and come out tonight for homecoming and hopefully help the Tigers get that win.
For Arkansas Pine Bluff, it has been a disappointing season, but if you haven't seen Benjamin Anderson, their quarterback play, he might be one of the best in the SWAC.
He's a real treat. And, of course, he's the best athlete for them offensively. He leads the team in rushing. He has over 300 yards. He's also the leading passer. This guy can do it all. He could be the first Arkansas Pine Bluff quarterback to throw for 10,000 yards in a career. So they're very, very happy about him. And, as I said, he's the guy that keeps this train on the track.
He had a huge game last week indeed. Hopefully the Tigers can contain Benjamin Anderson and company today. The TSU Tigers, the Golden Lions of Arkansas Pine Bluff, and our kickoff is straight ahead.
When we send an IBW electrician to your job site, I expect my electrical worker to be neat. I expect him to be professional. I expect him to be on time. I expect him to be productive. I expect him to do everything in his power or her power to ensure that employer is successful. Because what's going to get us more work is successful jobs.
The time is now to hire IBW electricians.
Why does she pack these things? I ate one by accident last time, and we won. It's good luck. But it tastes like a dirty old tree branch. What the heck is Quino? But this is for first place.
What is that, a loofah?
It's a Quino.
Bud Light, for the fans who do whatever it takes.
The Tigers will get the football first. This is the 42nd meeting all time between TSU and Arkansas Pine Bluff. Tyler Strickland will put the toe into it for the Pine Bluff Golden Lions, and the Tigers will have a chance to make a play. It's Wilcox from the three. LaTevin Wilcox waiting for a hole to open, but he's dropped shy of the 25-yard line.
That's a good part spot to start from for the Tigers. They can come out, and, you know, this is so important because you look at this Arkansas Pine Bluff team, and they have been able to score points this year, but they have not been able to stop anybody. And so let's take a look at some of the starting lineups now on defense.
The defensive starters, Antonio Jenkins, one of the big play guys, Willie Duncan, the linebacker.
Gamble and Lyles, too. The big guys up front are going to do a heck of a job.
So Homer Causey, back at quarterback, completing 52% of his passes on the season. Throwing across his body. First play from scrimmage, able to hit Fred Plummer up around the 40. Picks up 16 yards on the first play. Welcome back, Homer Causey.
And it's interesting that they would let Homer start with a pass. Great way to start the game, get his confidence up. He rolls out to his left, throws back across the middle, and Plummer is wide open right there for the catch. A really nice play.
Good look at Fred Plummer. His 19th catch of the season. The Tigers with just one play. Out with good field position. Davion Porter, he is the tailback. Trying to pick forward for a couple of yards. He will finally be dropped by Kyle Walker.
Good push up front by that big offensive line. By the time Porter hit the line, he had a lot of room to go. Now let's take a look at some of the starters on offense for the Tigers.
It's just good to have Homer Causey back. You see Porter along with Denson, the fullback, Plummer and Cross, the skill position players, and there's your big men up front.
A lot of experience at the wide receivers between Fred Plummer and Malik Cross, and that always helps. And now you got the veteran quarterback back in the backfield. So the Tigers are really expecting big things today.
Tigers going with four wide receivers in this formation because he will try and run. He was tripped up and then dropped, unable to get any further yardage.
That was Causey on that zone read, and, you know, the quarterback has to make the choice, and he kept it there, and that's a nice game for TSU. Tadra Pampling on the stop right there for Arkansas Pine Bluff.
So it brings up a third and seven. The Tigers need to reach the midfield stripe right at the 50 in order to get a first down. They'll bunch three receivers to the top of your screen. Porter left end to block, no one there. The very small rush for the Golden Lions. That pass just put up for grabs. It was nearly picked. That ball just floated on Causey. The nearest man was Lawrence Mosley, a defensive back, a freshman, but he couldn't get there.
You got to wonder about that one because he had all day to pass. I think there was a mix-up. It looks like Plummer went left when he thought he was going to go right because he had all day to find a receiver on that one and just could not connect.
Corey Carter on to punt. Averages 47 yards a kick. That is number one in FCS college football. What a leg. A booming kick back near the goal line. That football is picked up, and then it'll be marked at about the half-yard line with forward progress.
What
Marvante King.
Yes. 23, Michael Holmes. Watch the play he makes. They can't really handle it, but he's down there in a hurry. It's right near the goal line, and he, what a play. Got that one hand wrapped around him and yanked him down in the end zone. It was that close to being a safety, and that would have been the way to kick off homecoming.
Well, they tell you not to field punts inside about the 9 or 10-yard line. He fielded that to the goal line, and lucky he did maybe even fumble.
Well, he was flirting with danger, no doubt about that one, because he hauled it in. He could not make the clean catch. And Michael Holmes down there doing a great job for the Tigers.
Our first look at Benjamin Anderson. Last week against Grambling, nearly 500 yards total offense. He will throw maybe from his own end zone, deep in the end zone. He's able to fire on the boundary and get a completed pass. It was Willie Young, his 26th catch of the year.
Willie Young, take a look. It's Anderson. Kind of started out the same way the Tigers did. Anderson rolling to his left. That's a great throw. When you're rolling out to your left, he throws back across, has his man Willie Young for a fine connection and a first down right there for the Golden Lions.
Butch, that shows the confidence they have in Benjamin Anderson to throw that deep in his end zone on the first play from scrimmage. One thing about Arkansas Pine Bluff, though, the running game has been a work in progress, and really since the first week. It is not an area they're able to get a lot of yards on the ground. That time it was Brian Hanley. And here's a look at your TSU defensive starters here this afternoon. Golden Lions rush for right around 138 yards a game. They're much more proficient through the air. See what they want to do here on second and 10. Arkansas Pine Bluff ninth in the conference in scoring. They average less than 24 a game. Their last three games, though, they've been able to pick up some points. Maybe Anderson has had his best games, and that time he was chased out of bounds.
That's one of the things Coach Asbury was telling me this week, that they had to do was contain this guy, keep him inside the pocket, because he likes to run. He's the leading rusher on this team, so they know he will pull it down. As you can see, he thought about it, but a lot of Tigers were right there waiting for him to pull that ball down, and he decided to take it out of bounds. Jarius Moore, number 33, right there for the TSU Tigers.
Moore, the number one leading tackler on this defense. See if he's involved again. Third and 10. Anderson back inside his five. Cox to throw, so able to complete his pass. Whips one into the hands. Up across the 25-yard line for a first down. It looks like Marvante King, who screwed up that punt return, able to make the catch and get the first down here.
Well, he's a freshman. Marvante's King is a freshman. Last week he had a 78-yard touchdown reception. So this guy has some nice hands. He makes a good catch there, but you could really check out Anderson's arm there. He just zipped that one in there.
Talking about a guy who's just shy of 1,500 yards passing this season. Last week, threw for 467. And now just scrambling, trying to get something, could not do it. Arthel Wire was there with company to drop Anderson for a one-yard loss.
LaKendrick Connolly up there in a hurry, and so far early in this game, the Tigers are sticking to the game plan. They are really bottling him up in the pocket, and they're not giving him any chance to get outside.
He's also looking to throw across his body, oftentimes drifting to his left rather than his right, which creates that extra second of having to turn and fire. Anderson back to throw. All alone is Marvante King here at the bottom of your screen. Good move by King. He'll get the first down and more. He's up shy of the 45-yard line. That's a big gain of nearly 20 yards.
Great throw on the play, but he's their big play threat. He can catch it, and he has the wheels to go a long way with the pass. As you can see, Marvante King takes it in right there, and then look at him cutting back across field, and that's going to be a big gain for the Golden Lions.
A lot of Tigers just chasing Marvante King. Couple of catches today, giving him just 16 on the year, Butch. But last week against Grambling, he caught 182 yards worth of passes. He's become a favorite target of this man. Anderson is going to run for an additional 11 or 12 and move the sticks again.
Tigers are going to have to stay patient right there. Michael Holmes coming up to make the stop, but that's the first time that Anderson was able to get outside of the containment and pick up a first down. As you can take a look right here, great fake, and that had a lot to do with allowing him to get along the outside and picking up that first down.
Pick up a few yards here on the ground. It's Brian Hanley again. Now, he's not listed on there too deep as far as running backs, but he's had a few carries on this drive, and he picks up six on the play.
Before being knocked down by Derek Lyles, and that guy's had an outstanding season so far for TSU. He seems like he's always in the backfield trying to make something happen.
Pine Bluff on the march here. Anderson has a lot of room to the boundary if he wants to run. He's going to throw downfield instead, and the pass landed between two targets. Wesley Hawthorne was the man closest. Also along for the ride was Willie Young.
You could see Anderson looking deep, and for the TSU defensive backs, they're going to have to be alert every time they're on the field, because this guy is going to put that pressure on you. He's going to see, try to get that one-on-one coverage down the field, and he's going to test you. So they can expect that to happen a lot today.
Of course, this TSU defense, number one in the SWAC against the pass. You love this matchup between that man, Benjamin Anderson, and this defense trying to stop the passing game. Now they'll go to the ground with Hanley. Hanley to the 30, inside, stays on his feet. He allowed the first down and more. Inside the Tiger red zone, down to the 16-yard line. A couple of big plays. That one on the ground from Brian Hanley.
Before Jarius Moore finally pulled him down there, but another zone read, except this time he gives off the ball to Hanley, and Hanley's rolling pretty good. I know they've had trouble running the ball this year, but that looks pretty good. He gets out into the open, makes a nice cut, and that's a huge gain for the Golden Lions.
Just feels like the TSU defense has been a step slow in a couple of plays, unable to make tackles in space. See the sunshine of the shadows contrast as you get down to the red zone here for the Golden Lions on the march. Remember, this drive started on their 1.5-yard line. They're trying to go 99-plus. There is a flag down. Probably good news for the Tigers, because otherwise they'll have a first and goal with the Lions at the 3.
Trey Walker guided him out of bounds there, but as you said, that flag down. In his
shot block. Offense, 63 and 76. 15-yard penalty. Repeat first down.
Perry Joyner, one of the guilty parties. Two men involved, one goes low. You'll probably get the chop block, and let's see if we can pick it up here. There it is, easy call on the left side of your screen.
He did, and Anderson took it right up the middle, and that's a huge break for the Tigers, because they were looking at first and goal from about the 3, and now the penalty is going to push them back.
Not only are they trying to go 99-plus to score, they're going to have to overcome some big penalties in the process. Golden Lions 0-4 on the road. It's not had anything to do with the play of that man, Benjamin Anderson. You're looking at a player that was a first-team all-conference performer in 2011 and 2012. That's his freshman and sophomore campaigns. Now as a senior trying to lead this team, that's a bad pass into traffic. Could have been picked and was dropped. It was Darvion Trahan who was there. He probably had the best opportunity. Two Tigers competing for the pick.
He and Michael Holmes. Check this out. I mean, one of them was going to pick it off, and then they kind of ran into each other right there and kind of knocked the ball down. And that's a huge break right there for the Golden Lions, because that could have been a TSU turnover very easily. He got hit right as
that's he
tried to throw the ball, and that really affected the pass, and it was almost picked off.
Good there. Call, Butch. It was Salisbury from the defensive end position that hit the arm of Anderson that kept him from getting much on that throw. So now it's 2nd and 25. They have to reach the 11 for a first down. Anderson waiting for something to develop. Able to find his underneath men on 3 different occasions here on this drive. Joel Porcia with his 12th catch of the year, the LA native.
Demetrius Johnson was up there in a hurry to make the play too, to knock him down. And you could see the Tigers just dropping back in that zone, and they left the underneath wide open, and Anderson, being the veteran quarterback that he is, took advantage of it.
You could see him, Butch, looking deep initially, and if nothing is there, coming underneath. But sometimes those underneath passes have been worth 10, 15 yards.
LeTevin Wilcox also getting in on the action for the Tigers there. And now we have a big third down.
Third and long. There's Hanley out of the backfield. Blockers set up ahead of him. Hanley earlier got a big gain. This time he'll pick up sizable yards, but he's shy of the marker. He's inside the 10. Remember, he had to get to about the 7.
Good play by Michael Holmes and Darvion Trahan. Both of them right there for a big, big stop. And now it's going to bring up fourth down. And looks like the Golden Lions are going to kick it after all.
Try and settle for 3 points to get on the scoreboard first. Tyler Strickland is the kicker. He's made 5-11 field goals on the year. But 0-3 from really long range. So that's probably not indicative of how accurate he has been. From the hold of Nyheiser, the punter, this kick is on the way, and it is through. 6:33 to play here in our first quarter. The Golden Lions strike first. The visitors from Arkansas Pine Bluff lead the TSU Tigers 3-0.
Training is about more than muscle. It's about inner strength. So I push myself. That's why I serve in the United States Coast Guard. I train with the best. A team that shares my drive and commitment. We collect intelligence, guard our shores against drug smugglers, and keep our waterways safe, because our nation expects more.
If you expect more, maybe you were born ready. Find out at GoCoastGuard.com.
Oh, come on! That's a hole!
I hate watching with Ramsey. All he does is yell. They can't hear you, Ramsey. But every time he's come over this year, we've won. And he always brings Bud Light. Little dog won't come out from under the couch. But we're winning. I love you, Ramsey.
Bud Light, for the fans who do whatever it takes.
Strickland knocked through 3 points, matching his uniform number. And the Golden Lions from Arkansas Pine Bluff on the scoreboard first here on Homecoming 2014 for the Texas Southern Tigers, and they'll get the football back. So Strickland ready to send it from the sunshine into the shadows. Here on a bright, sunny day inside BBVA Compass Stadium. This one will come right into your living room. From about the 3-yard line, it's Wilcox. Wilcox with a seam, has to beat the kicker. And he'll cut back in front of Strickland before he's finally popped out of bounds. With great field position. What a play by LeTevin Wilcox.
And boy, it could not have come at a better time, because the Tigers, right after you give up 3 points, you like to come back with a big return. He does. Takes it right down the hash, and then he cuts it back to the outside. And at this point, I thought he might be gone. It was just the kicker left, and I'm sure some of his teammates are going to have some fun with him about that.
A little stutter step, and he got popped out of bounds. He gains 56 yards on the kickoff. So Homer Causey back as the starting quarterback this week for TSU. The junior from Atlanta looked like he had the Tigers on the march before their drive stalled in their only other try. He'll operate from the gun. Here comes the rush. Causey able to step out of trouble and find Porter. Porter has all kinds of running room. He'll have the first down and more. Davion Porter, he gets a block. He'll head to the pylon. Davion Porter in from 41 yards. What a play!
Davion Porter. And one of the keys, you have to credit Causey for staying calm under the pressure, because he kind of scrambled around long enough to make that happen. And as you're going to see, he's under a lot of heat. The blitz came right up the middle. He got by the blitz, saw Davion Porter, and then this is all Porter. This is a fantastic run. He cuts back across the grain, sees the goal line, and he is gone. A beautiful touchdown play by the Tigers.
Tremendous individual effort on that replay, as you saw from Causey, to get out of trouble and then to make something happen by Porter on the flip, the 41-yard score. Here is Medina's extra point, but the play was blown dead.
Illegal substitution. Defense. Half the distance to the goal. Retry the kick.
A referee today, Eddie Kelly. And the Tigers will do it again. Davion Porter, though, able to provide the first touchdown and an exciting play here on Homecoming.
Davion Porter showing you why he's ranked in the top five in the SWAC in rushing yards and rushing touchdowns, because he can do things like that. You get a guy like that in open space like that, he can really make something happen, and he did right there.
It's rare to see somebody on the left boundary take it all the way across and score at the right pylon, but he did it. And the extra point from Medina is true. So just like that, the Tigers answer the three from Pine Bluff with seven of their own. 6:06 to play here in our first quarter. Homecoming at Texas Southern University.
I'm Percy Cruzo. If you haven't been to French's Chicken, or if it's been a while since your last visit, no place does chicken like French's. Our chicken is seasonized with our blend of Creole herbs and spices. Our side dishes include the tastiest greens and red beans and rice you'll ever put in your mouth. Try our new King Roll Rotisserie Chicken at our Scott Street location. Come on by French's Chicken, where the taste lasts forever.
Who cares?
The environment is my passion. Every day I live for the outdoors and all of its challenges. That's why I enlisted in the Coast Guard. Now, I serve to protect the environment and defend my country. It's like I was born for this.
Were you born ready for a greater challenge? Find out at GoCoastGuard.com.
Not sure what you tell Homer Causey after that play. One play, 41 yards and a touchdown.
You say go back and do it again. That's what you say.
Good job, kid.
Coach Asbury just had to be very happy about that, seeing his starter back in there, back in action and making a play like that.
It's Marvante King in hopes of returning this kickoff from Medina. There's the run up in the boots. A returnable kick that'll come down inside the 10-yard line. Kevin Alexander. Alexander with a nice return up shy of the 35. One of the up men.
Brandon Thomas helping to get him out of bounds. But as you were saying before, Brett, that was one heck of a drive. And it started with the big kickoff return. That's what set it all up. LeTevin Wilcox getting out in the open and getting him up over mid, past midfield. And then here's the big one. Homer Causey, under pressure, gets away from the blitz, scrambles around, keeps his head about him, finds Davion Porter open, and then you just watch this guy. This is music right here. Put some music to this, and this is great. He could use that tonight at the homecoming dance.
Brian Hanley wants to make a big play himself. Brian Hanley just clipped off about 26 yards on the first play from scrimmage. He was dropped by Demetrius Johnson, the corner, who had a long run to bring him down.
Darvion Trahan also helping out. But as you can see, he gives him the ball and just great blocking. You can see the receivers downfield setting their blocks. And I think maybe the Tigers thought coming into this game, they might see a little bit more pass than run. And the Golden Lions are trying to get that rushing game going a little bit.
It has been an area that I called a work in progress to start this game, but you've seen them clip off at least two big plays. Hanley wants another. No rest for the weary after that previous play. He'll be chopped down after he gained a couple of yards. That time, nothing doing. Wilcox able to make the play from his safety spot.
You know, they kind of use a three-back rotation, and whoever has the hot hand, he's going to get the carries. Right now, it's Hanley, and boy, he's looking very comfortable running that football. He finally gets a blow, though. They're taking him out. He needs one after those two runs.
Aaron Legrone, who's listed as the number one tailback, will be in for Benjamin Anderson. Anderson does a lot of it on the ground himself. Last week, he ran for two scores, 66 yards, with that 533 yards of total offense performance against Grambling. Scored a lot of points, 39, but they still gave up 63. Over the middle. The pass is complete, may go for a touchdown, and will into the end zone for the Arkansas Pine Bluff Golden Lions. C.J. Branch, the tight end, rumbles in, and Pine Bluff answers.
Well, we were just talking about how Anderson sees the entire field so well. This time he has time to pass, makes the fake off of the zone read, and has a man wide open over the middle. He takes it all the way down there, and look at him into the end zone. That's C.J. Branch for the touchdown, a big play there. And last week you mentioned Anderson had like 467 yards passing, you know, for two touchdowns there. So he's picking up right where he left off.
Branch, 6'2", 250 pounds, able to get ahead of steam, started to rumble in space. And the extra point is good. So Arkansas Pine Bluff leads 10-7. Let's take a look at the team uniforms presented by Russell Athletic. TSU in their maroon uniforms and white pants here today. Visitors, of course,
there
in
we go.
Whites.
And you know, if you look good, Brett, most of the time you play good. Tigers pull those uniforms fresh out of the box last week, have them back on today, and you know, so far it's really working for the offense.
Hey, it's been a fun beginning to this game, Butch, with some of the plays we've seen really from both teams.
It's exciting, and TSU has to come right back and answer this call, because watching, you look at Pine Bluff, and this year they may be 1-6 on the year, but they've had no problem scoring. The biggest problem has been on defense, so the Tigers have to keep that pressure on.
See Christopher Lee back, hoping to return the kick from that man, Tyler Strickland, who's already knocked through a field goal and an extra point. So the good news, the Tigers will get the ball back. The bad news, they're trailing again by 3 points. Strickland's got a pretty big leg. This time he won't even give Wilcox a chance to return it. Knocked it out of bounds. A good field position for TSU.
Flag down on the play, so that's the ball going out of bounds.
Kick out of bounds. Number three of the kicking team. Re-kick.
It shows you how the Tigers, instead of just taking the ball at the 40-yard line, they'd rather make Pine Bluff kick again.
Here we go on the replay, and as you can see, Hanley, he's just kind of, you know, the run is helping to set up the pass in this case because he's just, you know, he's right there burning the Tigers with these big runs, and in essence is giving Anderson time to pass because you got to make sure Hanley doesn't have the football.
And there's Branch finding the end zone. Brian Hanley came in less than 200 yards rushing on the season, but his two big plays have given Anderson a chance to throw and pick up a score through the air. Now Strickland will have to kick again. So some teams might just take the football at the 40, but after that big return from Wilcox on the previous kickoff, the Tigers would like to see him get another shot. So the two deep men stand right around the 10. And it will be Wilcox again from the 11. Right up between the hashes. Wilcox will be chopped down shy of the 35, but decent field position for TSU.
Patrick Rowland right there to help knock him down, a fine play. And as you can see, I guess it worked out for him. Got a nice gain on another good kickoff return. And right now it looks like the Golden Lions are almost unstoppable, but this happened a little bit last week. At halftime, TSU made those defensive adjustments, and they pretty much shut out Alcorn in the second half last week. So they will make those adjustments on defense.
Homer Causey making sure those gloves fit before he's ready to snap the football. Three receivers, trips to the right. And Causey will try and run, but he will not get anywhere. He'll be dropped and hit hard. Just no running room whatsoever. Kawan Cummings Jr., a sophomore defensive lineman from Little Rock, dropped him.
Kawan Cummings and all, watch the Golden Lions here. Everybody stayed in their lanes. Nobody left their lanes. And so when Homer stepped up into the pocket there, he really had nowhere to go because the tackles just collapsed inside.
This is a well-balanced offensive team for TSU, and I'll explain more after this next snap. But now they're facing a second and 13. Really, they want to stay away from these downs. Causey rolling and throwing, going up top, and oh boy, looked like he had six. Fred Plummer had a step, but the ball was knocked away at the last second by Jared Turner, the safety, to save six.
Jared Turner saved the touchdown there. Homer Causey just quite didn't get enough air on that ball. He saw how open he was. He wanted to get it to him and didn't get enough air over the top, but look at Fred Plummer there. He's like, that was six, guy. Homer's like patting his chest, saying, my bad, my bad.
So last week I had a team 298 yards passing, 297 running, and I said, well, you can't get much more balanced than that. But the Tigers, 189 on the ground, 189 through the air. You can get more balanced than that. But on third and 13, no doubt what they want to do, they'll go up top. There's Stephen Carpenter. He'll make the catch shy of midfield, and he'll gain 16 yards on the catch. Stephen Carpenter able to grab his 16th catch of the year, matching his uniform number.
Last time they were home, Stephen Carpenter had a big game, and he's right back picking up where he left off. A beautiful pass from Causey.
Here's Davion Porter quickly to the line of scrimmage. The Tigers snapped the football and let Porter rumble for 4 or 5 on first down.
That was a big conversion on that third down because the last thing they wanted to do was punt the ball back over to Arkansas Pine Bluff at this point.
After two rough plays, able to pick up 16, 17 yards. Now they're in Arkansas Pine Bluff territory, and Porter will run again. Porter has the first down. Little cutback, but then he's dropped. Really looked like he was trying to make one more move to get in space, but he was tackled by LaFerrell Franklin, getting the start from a linebacking spot today, but the sticks move. TSU team, they won their first four games of the year. They've lost now two of their last three. They really would like a win today, as Butch said in the open, get that winning season clinched, keep things going in the SWAC, and set up a big matchup next week with Grambling here at home. Causey to throw on the slant. Carpenter again inside the 25-yard line. He had the step in a good position. Causey hit him in stride, and Alexander dropped him.
Causey knew where he was going with that football the whole time. He was watching him on that quick slant. As soon as he made his break, that football is right on the money. Nice catch by Carpenter with a big Tigers first down.
See if the Tigers go back to the ground after they picked up the sticks. They will with Porter. Porter trying to dance between tacklers. Not a lot of room available before he's bottled up and thrown down by Jontrell Lockett, a defensive lineman.
Good answer by the Tigers, though. You know, you give up a touchdown really quick like that, you want to get the ball and get a good drive going the other way, and that's exactly what they're doing.
Nearing the red zone, facing a second and eight. Causey up top, and that pass too tall for Malik Cross at the goal line.
Pass is a little high, and Cross had some company, too, so he was very much aware of that. You can see Causey back, and he fired it in there. He was trying to get that ball in between three defenders, and might have been a good thing it was a little high. I'm sure Malik says yes, it's a good thing it was a little high.
Butch, we've seen the Golden Lions rush four. They haven't shown much as far as blitz today. You a little surprised at that?
I am. The one time they blitzed, though, Causey burned them for the touchdown.
I guess a four-man rush can still cause problems here. Causey has one man to beat, and he can't do it. Boy, it looked like he was going to be able to slither inside to pick up some additional yards. Nothing was available. It was Willie Duncan III, an outstanding linebacker, the team's leading tackler, who was just not going to let Causey get away.
This is one of those plays where I wonder if the knee isn't quite 100% yet, because he's out there, he's got one man to beat. If that's earlier in the year, he beats that guy and he probably picks up 10 or 15 more yards, but he's not quite as mobile as he used to be. But Tigers will now have to attempt a long field goal. Looks like 41 yards maybe.
41-yard try from Medina, who's long this season is 47. He's missed just two field goals, so a very accurate kicker. This will be a test. No wind inside BBVA Compass today. Good placement, low kick on its way, and it is good. 41-yard field goal. So Medina, a little look to the heavens. He's tied the game at 10 with a line drive three-pointer. Hey, don't miss the TSU women's soccer team take on Southern University tomorrow, October 26th. That'll be a 2 o'clock game at Durley Stadium. Tickets are on sale now. Log on to tsuball.com today. Who's scheduling a soccer game on an afternoon following a big homecoming night?
You saw Coach Darryl Asbury walk over and give Chris a big, big thump right there. And because he knew how important that was. You don't want to waste a drive or waste an opportunity to put points on the board, and that was a big field goal to tie this game up.
Good look at Coach Asbury. Seen a lot of progress this year, a chance to go 4-2 in the SWAC, 6-2 overall with the win, and which I think maybe they have to be a little bit surprised by what they've seen out of Arkansas Pine Bluff and their explosiveness offensively, but the TSU defensively back on the field to see if they can make some adjustments.
Well, Coach Asbury told me this week that he was a little concerned about the seniors going into a homecoming game at home as their last go around. He said he was working extra hard to make sure those guys were focused on their business, and, you know, maybe it just takes a little while to get rolling.
Real high kick that was taken near the boundary by Clinch. What? He'll bring
big
it out
shot
to the
right there. Brandon Thomas came out of nowhere, I think, and made a big, big hit there on the kickoff return.
Here's your scoring summary.
Homer Causey, he looks pretty good, though. I mean, we mentioned that maybe on that last run the knee may have been bothering him some, but so far he looks very, very good. The zone read, the handoff to Porter. Porter's always going to be a factor, and that pass was right on the money. I mean, he is throwing the football really well today. And then Chris Medina on. The kick is placed, and he just drilled it right down the middle.
Anderson, time to throw. In space, able to hit Isaiah Ferguson in stride. He's into Tiger territory. So Butch, just one play at a big gain of 25 yards, has the Lions on the move.
Darvion Trahan coming up to make the – but we're getting a passing exhibition here. Both quarterbacks really throwing the football well, and I tell you, you don't really have time to get up and go to the fridge or go to buy a Coke or do anything here because you're going to miss something if you leave.
He threw for almost 3,000 yards last year. Now he'll give to Hanley. Hanley's had a couple of big runs and add another to that list. Trahan dropped him, but that's a gain of 16 yards, and he's had three runs alone that have had the Tigers tackling air.
This one's all Hanley, though. Look at this move. I mean, he made some great moves, a little shake and bake, goes through this until he gets into the secondary, and he's finally pulled down by number 9, Darvion Trahan, in the secondary. So right now, the Golden Lions have a good mix of passing and running, right? They kind of have the Tigers off balance at this point.
They certainly do. Now, Anderson will flip one out to the boundary, and his pass was incomplete. It looked like he had the option to run or pass. He tried to find Portia, who would have had maybe 7-8 yards on the play, but it was a rare incompletion.
It's the worst pass Anderson has thrown all day. He had a guy standing like 5 feet from him, and he threw it in the ground.
A little bit later on, we're going to talk about where Anderson's career stats have him lined up with some of the greats in this conference. Maybe one final play here in our first quarter. Hanley finds running room a little more difficult to come by as the Tigers surround him. Still picks up a couple of yards
That's
on the play,
end of
and
the
he
first
was dropped
quarter.
By Derek McWilliams. And that'll bring us to the end of our first quarter. Entertaining back and forth. Quarter number one is through from BBVA Compass. The Tigers and the Golden Lions are tied at 10.
Hello, I'm Alan Helfman, Vice President of River Oaks Chrysler Jeep and Dodge. This is my friend and customer, Ms. Georgia Provost. River Oaks Chrysler Jeep and Dodge has the all-new, totally redesigned Chrysler 300. River Oaks Chrysler Jeep and Dodge has the all-new, totally redesigned Jeep Grand Cherokee.
Alan is the only car dealer I will ever buy a car from.
Come see us at Kirby in the Southwest Freeway.
Training is about more than muscle. It's about inner strength. So I push myself. That's why I serve in the United States Coast Guard. I train with the best. A team that shares my drive and commitment. We collect intelligence, guard our shores against drug smugglers, and keep our waterways safe. Because our nation expects more.
If you expect more, maybe you were born ready. Find out at GoCoastGuard.com.
It's the end of an era.
All the parties. The stories.
I'm gonna miss your smell.
You were my first.
What?
I knew it.
It's true.
Oh man, I'm sorry I broke your leg.
I wrote a song. Sorry. Here we go.
Keep the good times going with the crisp, refreshing taste of Bud Light. Here we go.
Whoa! Check out this new couch.
TSU and Arkansas Pine Bluff tied at 10 as we start the second quarter. Let's send things downstairs and introduce the third member of our crew. It's Nick Strong.
Guys, what a beautiful day down here in BBVA Compass Stadium. It's the homecoming experience, TSU versus Pine Bluff. Got a great game here, guys, 10-10. But you got to remember on the sidelines, a lot of emotion, guys trying to win this ball game. It was number 4, Homer Causey, the quarterback for the TSU Tigers, getting his guys together, talking about leadership, what he wants to do in today's game. After every score, Homer Causey, he will not, trust me, he will not, he says he's not going to lose his ball game. Back up to you guys.
Benjamin Anderson might have other ideas. His throw a little bit low. He had a receiver open, but his pass dropped incomplete. Intended that for Aaron Legrone out of the backfield.
Good coverage right there by Jarius Moore. The former North Shore player was right on target there, and the pass is just a little low. So that's he can throw a bad pass. That's good to know. We've seen two of them.
Just saw a 41-yard field goal from Medina. Now Tyler Strickland on to try and knock one through from what may almost be 43 yards. 6 of 12 this year. Pretty good from this distance on the season. Here's a kick. It's on the way. It is long enough, and it is through. Both field goal kickers knocking a long one right through the uprights. Tyler Strickland, his second field goal today. And with that, the Golden Lions back on top, 13-10. Hey, you can catch every home game live via our web stream. TSUball.com/live. TSUball.com for your number one source for Tiger football. Special teams, Butch, they made some plays. One big kick return for that man's team. for TSU and a couple of long field goals.
Every aspect of the game is contributing in this one for both teams. And it's like you said earlier, it's really a fun game to watch because it's a very exciting game to this point. And I know that man, Darryl Asbury, would like his see his defense tighten up a little bit, you know, force a three and out or something and get the ball back over for the offense to kind of stop this, you know, to change the rhythm of this game a little bit.
We're going to talk about Monty Coleman, the coach of Arkansas Pine Bluff, his distinguished football career a little bit later on. Meanwhile, the Tigers ready to get the football back. LaChristopher Lee hoping for his chance, along with Wilcox. They're both at about the seven. We've already seen the leg from this man, Tyler Strickland, a few times here this afternoon. So Arkansas Pine Bluff winless in conference, 0-4, hoping to change that on the road here today. And this kick will be in the direction of Wilcox from the six. Wilcox up the right hash, holds on to the football, planted at about the 26. Here's your scoring summary from this previous drive for the Golden Lions.
Anderson, it took them six plays. They go 42 yards, and they did it in a minute and 13 seconds before they got the field goal. Of course, Hanley making some big plays on the ground, and right there, somebody tried to yank it out, but he held on to that football. And so far, we've seen an offensive shootout coming into this ball game, and there's the field goal right there to put Arkansas Pine Bluff back in front.
So we heard from Nick on Homer Causey, what he's doing between drives. He's back out there now on the field with a five wide receiver formation, a flag at the line of scrimmage. Quick pass to Carpenter, his third grab already today. He'll gain 6 or 5 yards on the play. See if maybe the Lions lined up both sides.
Outsides, defense, number one. 5 yard penalty, repeat first down.
That's the corner, Dave White. How does a corner line up both sides? I'm not sure, but he did. You're not supposed to be on the wrong side when you're a corner.
That doesn't happen very often, but.
Tigers outgained in total yards, 213 to 102 in the first quarter, so maybe they're fortunate only to be down three. One of their big plays came on special teams. Now Homer Causey twisting and turning, fighting for yards. He'll gain about 10 on the play until Lucien, a defensive lineman, got a hold of him.
That looked like a design quarterback draw there because he had an empty backfield, and you could see the big tackle pulling there, the guard, number 71. Adrian Jackson pulled, made a big block, and then Causey did the rest, getting inside. Nice pickup there for the first down.
Feels like neither team has been backed up inside, say, their own 30, with the exception of the one time the Golden Lions started from their one-yard line. Just a couple of plays. They're out near midfield. Now Porter trying to find a crease. Porter made something out of nothing. And he'll step out of bounds at about the 35-yard line. Another gain of 20 before Kevin Rucker Jr. escorted him out of bounds. But what a nifty run.
Again, more zone read. Porter just looking for the hole. Finds it. Breaks a tackle. And then they're just a great play right there by Devion Porter. And right now the Tigers have the Golden Lions off balance. You know, they play pass, they come back with the run, and they're doing a great job of mixing it up.
So on that replay, one good seal block here in the bottom of your screen. Hard to identify who it was, but no doubt he'll get credit in the film room on Monday. So the Tigers at the 35 of the Golden Lions. Causey wants it all, going up top, got a man, ball underthrown, incomplete, intended for Fred Plummer. Alexander there on coverage.
He was just a little late with that one, and there's a flag down again.
Outsides, defense, number 90. 5 yard penalty, second down.
Lucien, the guilty party, so the second offside.
First down.
On the Pine Bluff offense, it'll be first down and 5 to go. But you're right, Butch, there's been a couple of deep balls, both times just a little bit underthrown.
And that one, it may be the lack of action, too. You know, he's been out of action for a little bit. He had last week to practice a little bit to work on his timing. And that one might have been just a tad off. But he looks great, though. He's throwing the ball well. He's got a lot of pop on that ball. And right now he's got his team in the middle of a long drive.
Threw for 90 yards in the first quarter. Has his team on the march here in the second. And that play going backwards. Nothing available. It was Kendall Dawson with his first carry, the fullback out of Louisiana. He was dropped by DeMarcus Berry.
And again, it's that same zone read, and that time Clausey did not read it right because he probably should have kept the football because they were out there waiting on Denson to turn the corner, and not much there at all. They say he got a yard, so that was, you know, that was something out of nothing there.
Second and 9, Porter back in the game. He'll carry the football again. Shifty feet for Davion Porter, dives inside the 30 to about the 28. Kyle Walker came up from the safety spot to make a tackle.
Of course, Porter, Packers leading rusher. Great move there. And then, you know, when you're out of space and there's nothing else to do, you put that head down and get what you can get, and that's exactly what Porter did right there. He's having a fine season. And when the Tigers want to get that running game going, he's the guy they look to kind of jumpstart everything.
Little indecision here for Causey and company on an important 3rd and 3. The play clock inside 7 seconds. May have to think about a timeout if Causey doesn't snap it soon. 3 seconds to snap the football. He just gets it off in time. They will throw. Pass over the middle. What a catch made by the tight end. Larry Clark III, the receiver, I beg your pardon. He was high in the air and somehow held on to the football.
Great job by Larry Clark. But also look at Davion Porter. When we show that again, he did an outstanding job of stepping up and picking up the blitz and giving Causey that extra second to throw the ball to pick up that first down. Great block by Porter, great catch right there by Clark.
Rucker on the tackle, so much going on in that play, but a fresh set of downs for the Tigers. Here's Petipa. Boy, it's Causey who still has the football. Causey will keep, and he's inside the 20. He'll pick up 4 or 5 on first down.
Causey doing a good job just reading. At the last second, he pulled that football back, kept it, and goes around the left side for a nice gain. He picked up 5 yards right there. You see, he pulled it out. He may have missed the handoff. I can't tell. But he pulled it out.
He confused me.
He did something with it. A good play right there by Homer Causey.
Willie Duncan, the team's leading tackler, finally smothered him after officially a gain of 5. So the Tigers on the march, a long, sustained drive, Butch, featuring both passing and running.
And this is how you wear the other team's defense down. You make them out there. You make them have to work for everything. And that's what the Tigers are doing.
Causey towards the end zone. His pass is caught to touchdown. Malik Cross, his 6th of the season.
You talk about a pinpoint pass. He dropped that thing in the coverage, but he dropped it right over the defensive back's head. Take a look at Homer Causey in the pocket. Nice floating it in there and just beating the safety coming over to try to help. Beautiful pass by Causey. Good catch by Cross, and the Tigers are on the board again.
It's like 6 arms for the Golden Lions, 3 defenders, arms everywhere, but Malik Cross came up with the football. He has been the big play wide receiver this year. And the Tigers trying to add the extra point, courtesy of Medina. He will put one through the pipes. It is good. We'll step aside. 10:41 to play in our second quarter. The Tigers with the lead, 17-13.
Define the fabric of a team. It's not selfish. It's not boastful. It's about many, sewn together to reach one common goal. But in order to win, you must learn to work together.
homecoming. Texas Southern University, the Tigers, a bit of a slow start today, but they found their mojo, and they've also found a lead 17-13 over the Golden Lions. Take a look at the scoring summary after the kickoff, but the amount of passes and rushes, extremely efficient on that last sequence. Kick will be taken from about the 7-yard line. Looks like John Hawkins on the return.
Take a look at that scoring drive. You see 9 plays, but they go 74 yards, and they did a lot of it on the ground, and they did a lot of it in the air. Davion Porter carrying the load right there, carrying the mail on the ground, and then Causey with a couple of nice passes. That was a third down conversion to Larry Clark. That was huge. And then we're going to take a look. This is the touchdown into the end zone. Malik Cross with a great catch there and a nice pass to get that into a crowd.
Hanley finds running room tough to come by. LeKendre Conley on the tackle. In that first quarter, Hanley was averaging 11.3 a carry. Such a great resource to have a senior veteran quarterback so successful through the air like Anderson. There's a marker down. Anderson goes up top into triple coverage, and yet the ball was just about in the hands of his receiver, Ferguson. See what the penalty's all about. Almost in the area, maybe defensive holding of some sort. Going to referee today is Eddie Kelly.
Illegal substitution. Defense, number 89. 5-yard penalty.
You know, that's something the Tigers have pretty much stayed away from today. They haven't seen a lot of penalties to this point in the ballgame. He didn't quite get off the field. You can see him trying to run off the field there. That was Thomas.
That wasn't Wheat.
That was Thomas, and he didn't quite make it off the field. So 12 men on the field, and that's a defensive penalty.
Hanley, he was stopped for a small gain on the previous try, not this time. He'll churn off another 20 yards before Demetrius Johnson collared him. But another nice running play for Arkansas Pine Bluff.
Hanley has been extremely impressive as far as hitting that hole quickly. They slipped the handoff to him, and before you know it, boom, he's gone right through that hole. You don't have to maintain that block for that long when you have someone with that type of quickness. All you have to do is make that initial contact, and then he's gone.
It's given this offense an entirely different dimension. They've been nearly doubled up in the first half of games this season. Now Anderson trying to run, showing off some speed, gets a block, big time block, and Anderson jumps out of bounds after a 12-yard gain, and there's another late marker down. Not sure if this was considered a block at the back. The flag will be moved up to the spot of that vicious blow you saw Anderson circled around.
Well, it looked like one of the receivers peeling back to make a block. And you're right, Brent. I'm not sure what they're going to call here. Let's take a look and see.
Little debate or conversation. Conversation continues.
There's no foul for targeting. Against number 24 on the offense. Result of the play, the first down.
You know, Butch, even as that play developed, I was wondering why that marker came in. It looked like a clean block to me, but I like the fact that at least the officials got together and had this conversation. That's just being in the wrong place at the wrong time.
There's nothing you can do about that because you're giving chase and you can't see that guy coming from your blind side like that, and he just kind of takes you right out of the play. But it was a good job picking up the flag.
That's when you maybe consider basketball or baseball once you get declated by Marvante King. That's not any fun. The gain of 12 stands. Boy, it looked like the Tigers had a man in the backfield immediately, and that play was blown dead. I think it was Amir who came flying across. Derek Lyles.
Lyles made the tackle, but Amir just blew the whole thing up in the backfield. and they had no place to go. So Tigers are really getting aggressive on defense right now. And that's what you want this team in. You want them to have second and long, third and long. You want them to get them out of that third and three, third and four situation.
Yeah, step up and make some plays defensively. So a second and 13. Couple of long sustained drives for both teams here back to back. Little bubble screen. The pass to King, able to stay on his feet. King has the blocking set up to get inside the 40. Got a few of those yards back before Conley. LaKendra Conley's been a very busy man today, makes the stop.
What a dangerous pass here, though, is that quick little receiver hitch right there, that low receiver screen. And, boy, I thought for a second there Tigers might get their hands on it, but he came back. He could. It looks like his knee was almost down there on the play. But it's a nice game for a first down. Actually, didn't pick up the first down. It's going to bring up third and three now.
It's like almost a third and seven to go. Tigers will rush four. Three receivers to the right for the Golden Lions. Anderson has to race out of the pocket. Anderson with some speed. He will dive to the marker, and he is so close.
That's going to depend on the mark because I didn't think he would get that close to it. Great job by Anderson. He feels the pressure, scrambles out to his right, cuts it back over the middle, then right at the end, he's going to make a dive for that first down. And he got extremely close. Sure. I think one of the Tigers is down on the ground right now.
Looks like Derek McWilliams maybe got rolled up from behind. It was Jarius Moore on the stop, but one of the Tigers' big linemen being attended to. Two different 91s on your roster. Take your pick. One says Derek McWilliams. The other one says Caleb Jenkins.
We'll try to get word on that and find out who's down for the Tigers. And they're still looking over. And it looks like they're looking at the leg.
Let's hope he's okay. The play happened at the very end. He was lagging behind the play, but it looks like he's okay.
That's a good scene right there, watching that big fella jog off the field.
Looks like he's okay, and they're going to measure, meanwhile, see if this is a first down. See Jenkins on the far right side of your screen, maybe a better angle here. Oh, he got chopped a bit low on that block. Play, though, is good enough for a first down by the length of a football.
It came down to the spot, and the Golden Lions got a really good spot on that one. And now they're back in business again.
...17-13, Tigers with the lead, but the Golden Lions on the march.
Well, and that was third and seven, so the TSU had a chance to get the ball back, and they just could not make the stop.
Anderson down the middle, locates Isaiah Ferguson again. Trahan there on the stop, but that's inside the 20-yard line. Trahan lost his hat. He'll have to step out for a play and another first down for the Golden Lions.
Good job by Anderson reading. He had Jarius Moore on the blitz coming from the right side of your screen there, and he knew right where he was going with it immediately. He felt the pressure coming in, and he unloaded in a hurry, and they got another big first down. That Anderson is everything you expect from a veteran quarterback. I mean, that guy is calm, cool, and collected. Just goes to work.
He will give to Hanley, almost untouched. Races into the end zone from 18 yards out for the Golden Lions touchdown, Arkansas. Pine Bluff back in front.
We were just talking about how he hits the line of scrimmage so fast, and you got another example of it right there. Hanley takes the ball, cuts back to his left. He saw the hole, great vision, hit it, and that he was a very, very quick touchdown on that play.
Say this again, Hanley came into this game less than 190 yards rushing and more than 40 carries this year. He's on his way to about 200 yards this afternoon. The extra point from Strickland hits the upright. No good.
That could be huge. In a game like this where each team keeps exchanging scoring opportunities, to miss an extra point.
So the Golden Lions, their lead just 2-19-17, will step aside here on Homecoming from TSU.
When we send an IBW electrician to your job site, I expect my electrical worker to be neat. I expect him to be professional. I expect him to be on time. I expect him to be productive. I expect him to do everything in his power or her power to ensure that employer is successful. Because what's going to get us more work is successful jobs.
The time is now to hire IBW electricians.
Missed extra point. Trey Walker got up slowly after he tried to make the block on that kick. Looks like he's okay. The Tigers, though, down by two here in the second quarter.
Brent, we did find out that that was Caleb Jenkins, the number 91 who was injured on the field, who jogged off on his own power and appeared to be in good shape.
The Tigers will get the football back, so Strickland hit the upright on his extra point, just his second miss of the season. In fact, his first miss, the Christopher Lee from the five. And Lee got flipped and upended right at the 25-yard line. Tackle made by Rashid Boyd, so the Tigers have the football back. 6:39 to go in our second quarter. Here's the previous scoring summary for the Golden Lions.
And they took it down there. Nice mixture. You know, a couple of times they were in a big hole. They had second and third and long, but that quarterback, Benjamin Anderson, calm, cool, and collected under pressure. Scrambled out of the pocket there. That was a huge first down. He barely got it, but he got it. And then he comes around again in trouble, pulls it down, makes a nice pickup before Hadley came in and scored the touchdown. We had a nice pass there for another first down. And then Hadley came on and scored the touchdown, but they did miss the extra point. So it's only 19-17.
We feature the two quarterbacks in our open. Outstanding quarterback play for both teams. Here's Causey, actually tackled forward by Kyle Walker, wrapped him up and threw him forward. And Causey able to navigate a first down play for 6 yards.
Homer Causey on the keeper. You could see Causey on the bike right before the kickoff, trying to keep that knee loose. He was on the sidelines, and that's why, because he's got to keep himself warmed up and ready to go in this one. But a nice play pulling that ball down, and makes a nice game for the Tigers. 6 yards on the play.
Kind of a warm afternoon. He's got the long white sleeves on under his maroon TSU jersey. He's on the sideline trying to stay warm. But it's working today. Tigers back to their I formation. They've not been in this situation much today. Davion Porter up to midfield. Steps out of bounds at about the 48. Arkansas Pine Bluff. Alexander raced him out of bounds.
Take a look
so
at this one when we show it again, because the Golden Lions came with a couple of blitzes from the right side, and they did not get through. Tigers did a great job of picking it up. Porter breaks it off to the left, squeezes through the hole, and then this guy's been doing this all day. Gets right down the sideline. Nice game to put TSU right back, you know, over midfield, getting back in the scoring territory again.
Porter began today fourth in the SWAC in yards per game on the ground. He's not had a number of carries, but when he has been called upon, he's been exciting, including one screen pass that went 41 yards to the house They'll try and set him up for a screen here. Blocking set up. Porter steps through a hole at the 40. There's a marker down at the feet of one of the linemen, a center, in fact, Marvin Holly for TSU.
Let's take a look at that. If that's the call they're going to make, that's a horrible call because the defense defender turned his back to the offensive guy. We'll see if it is.
Block in the back. Offense.
He calls a block in the back.
10-yard penalty. Repeat first down.
And I don't know if we'll get to see it on the replay or not, but you could see the defensive guy literally turn his back to the blocker, and that's not much you can do when a guy's kind of falling into you backwards there, and you'll see it near the sideline. We was right at the bottom, but the officials called it, so it is a flag. But this is the type of game that makes you're almost afraid to miss your turn scoring.
It's true. That's a great point. If you get off schedule and you have an empty possession because of a penalty that sets you back or a turnover, makes it hard to kind of keep up in this shootout. Inside 5 minutes to go here in our first half. Causey with the quick handoff to Denson right into the pile. Nothing available for Kendall Denson. So it'll be second and call at a long nine for the Tigers into Arkansas Pine Bluff territory. Trailing by two after that mixed extra point following the last touchdown for Pine Bluff. Causey has two receivers each side. Took a hit as he let that football go, and it's going to be picked off. Intercepted by Kevin Rucker. He will be dropped with basically no return. An underthrown ball after the big hit for Causey.
That came that close to being a touchdown. Just the hit on Causey caused that ball to be underthrown.
Turnover, the Lions will have it when we come back.
Hello, I'm Alan Helfman, Vice President of River Oaks Chrysler Jeep and Dodge. This is my friend and customer, Miss Georgia Provost. River Oaks Chrysler Jeep and Dodge has the all-new, totally redesigned Chrysler 300. River Oaks Chrysler Jeep and Dodge has the all-new, totally redesigned Jeep Grand Cherokee.
Ellen is the only car dealer I will ever buy a car from.
Come see us at Kirby in the Southwest Freeway.
Training is about more than muscle. It's about inner strength. So I push myself. That's why I serve in the United States Coast Guard. I train with the best. A team that shares my drive and commitment. We collect intelligence, guard our shores against drug smugglers, and keep our waterways safe, because our nation expects more.
If you expect more, maybe you were born ready. Find out at GoCoastGuard.com.
Ugh, why does she pack these things? I ate one by accident last time, and we won. It's good luck. But it tastes like a dirty old tree branch. What the heck is Quino? But this is for first place.
What is that, a loofah?
It's a Quino.
Bud Light, for the fans who do whatever it takes.
19-17, the Golden Lions with the lead. Let's get an injury update from Nick Strong.
It's not looking good down here on the sidelines for cornerback Trey Walker. It looks as though he'll be out the game with an injury. The defense is really going to have to step up without his presence. Back up to you guys.
All right, thanks, Nick. Meanwhile, Demetrius Johnson dropped Hanley after another huge gain on first down.
Where has this guy been all season? This is incredible. Of course, he has a big hole right there, cuts through it, but he is one of these guys that's built low to the ground. He's a load, so he's tough to tackle, but he's got a lot of quickness and speed. And he gets through that line in a hurry. He really does. And he's really helping Mr. Anderson out today.
His individual numbers already through almost two quarters, more than what the team averages per game this season. And he'll add to it. Hanley, another first down run. He'll pick up maybe 13, 14 yards before Trahan makes the stop.
You know, this is going back a little bit, but remember Robert Newhouse with the Cowboys?
Sure.
He's built like that, a little spark plug, and he runs low to the ground. And you know, you're going to get hit. He's tough to bring down. He really is, and he's got some quickness, and now he's going to have to take a blow.
A couple of times he's been able to get to that second level before there has been a hand on him. That hasn't helped. Now Anderson tries to make a play, and he's unable to do so. Conley got him again. That has to be about the seventh or eighth tackle from LeKendre Conley here this afternoon.
He's doing a great job from that linebacker spot. And that time he got out and really brought him down one-on-one in the open. It was a good one-on-one tackle. He and Jarius Moore have really stepped up on the defense. You know, they lost Claiborne with that knee injury. And Jarius Moore and Connolly have really been doing a fine job picking up some of the slack.
Glad you mentioned Moore. He's the reigning defensive player of the week in the conference. Meanwhile, there's a pass down the middle for Willie Young. Incomplete, but a late marker in. Thrown in the area of maybe interference or holding on TSU.
Pass interference. Defense, number 21. 15-yard penalty, automatic first down.
Demetrius Johnson, the guilty party. That'll give another big gainer for the Golden Lions.
Well, if you're a Tigers fan, you don't want to see that happen because you don't want to give them something. You want to make them earn it. And there might have been a little contact there, but it was tough to see from that standpoint. Either way, it's a big first down for the Golden Lions.
Here's Legrone. Aaron Legrone's had just a couple of carries. He'll reach the 30 before Brandon Thomas steps in to wrap his arms around him. Which I thought it was a good point earlier. As an offense, you felt like it was important not to get off schedule. So the Tigers were on that march, but they were unable to score. They threw the pick, and now just like that, the Lions threatening again.
They come back, you get a big penalty, and before you know it, they're at your 30-yard line.
Second and five. Here as we near the two-minute mark in our first half. Two receivers each side in this formation for the Golden Lions, and they'll run with Hanley again. Hanley will churn forward to pick up the first down. He'll gain seven on the play, and the clock is stopped after the tackle made by Justin Wheat. Hey, catch the TSU football replay in HD after every home game. That's on Tuesdays at noon, only on CSN Houston, the home of Tiger football. Big crowd here today for homecoming. They can go home and watch the game next Tuesday on CSN, and a good one we have had through nearly two quarters, but the visitors from Pine Bluff, just one win on the year, 0-4 in conference play, have the lead, trying to do it again. Who else? It's Hanley. He's loose. He's into the end zone. That is a touchdown for Pine Bluff.
No,
23 yards.
No flags on the play, and they're doing an excellent job of spreading the field. You mentioned those two wide receivers to either side. The linemen are getting just a foot more of space inside, and it's creating some holes for this big guy. Look at this. I mean, he's going through. He's barely being touched on some of these plays.
You're right, Butch. That's a 23-yard run. He's not touched until he's 22 yards deep near the goal line.
Well, they're doing such a good job of spreading the field. You have your DBs so wide, everybody's wide. If you break that initial contact, there's nobody there.
And keep in mind, Trey Walker has been dinged up. We've seen Caleb Jenkins come off the field for the Tigers. They're playing some different guys today. Strickland, who missed the previous extra point, will knock that one through. So it's now a 26-17 Golden Lions lead.
I'm surprised they didn't go for two there. I know you know the old adage is you don't go for it until you need it.
Right.
But that might have been an opportunity to go for it. But, wow, the Tigers, I'm sure they feel like at this point we have to come back and see we can't get on the board before the half. It's a minute and 25 seconds left. And from what we've seen in this game, that's plenty of time.
26-17 our score. Hey, don't miss the TSU women's volleyball team take on Houston Baptist University. October 28th at 7 p.m. at the HPE Arena. Tickets on sale now. Log on to TSUball.com today.
You know, one of the things Coach Asbury told me this week, and as you can see, homecoming, that's what it's all about. A lot of people excited about that.
Had the parade today. Of course, some festivities here at the half. Looking like the homecoming court, the king and the queen will get their time at the break. We still have 1:25 to play, though, here in our second quarter. Tigers could use a nice return here to set up a drive inside 2 minutes. LeChristopher Lee just did stay in bounds at the three. Good directional kick. Very good open field tackle as well made by Pine Bluff. That is Lynch, and the Tigers do not have very good field position. And here's our scoring drive previously for Pine Bluff.
It was a great drive. They go 7 plays, 82 yards, and they did it in 2 minutes and 51 seconds with Hadley picking up a lot of the yardage just right there on the ground. I mentioned before how they did a really fine job of spreading the field, running that read option, slipping the ball inside, and there he is banging in for the touchdown. It was really a nice drive put together by the Golden Lions.
Pride of Monticello, Arkansas. Brian Hanley's had a big day. And we'll see how daring the Tigers want to be. That doesn't help. Causey trying to make a play, and there's Davion Porter. Porter scored on a long screen pass earlier, but this time he's dropped after a pickup of maybe 4 on the play. Tigers last week at Alcorn State lost 40-25, hoping for a better result today, but now they're just seeing if they can find maybe a big play to get some points here before the half. Homer Causey locates Fred Plummer. Plummer came back for that football, made the catch, races across the 30, steps out at the 31, where David White gets credit for the tackle, but that's good enough to move the sticks for TSU.
And he did a good job getting out of bounds because he wanted to get out of bounds and save him a little time on the play and come back and, like I said, see if they can't get a field goal or something in there. One of the things Coach Asbury was saying, I was saying a minute ago, was he wants to see this team close better. You know, they've been having some in the games late, and they just haven't closed the way he wanted to see them close. And here's Porter making another big play, or a Plummer, that is, before stepping out of bounds with the first down.
It's been the Memphis Natives with some big efforts today. There's another one. Fred Plummer, the senior, kept his feet inbounds. I think he got 2 inbounds. He only needed 1 right in front of David White, and that's a gain of 11. And another TSU first down.
Tigers doing a good job right now of taking what they're giving them right there near the sidelines and at the same time stopping the clock. So it's down to 37 seconds to go in the half. So I'm sure Darryl Asbury wants to get something on the board if they can.
We've seen 1 long field goal of 41 yards from Medina already today. So maybe 1 more play might get the Tigers in good field position. That won't help. Causey lucky to get the football back. Now he's just scrambling for his life. Throw this football away, Homer. He will downfield. He's got a man.
What a play.
Carpenter with the catch. Hey, that's a little Manziel in that play. Kevin Rucker, the tackle, but just like that, the Tigers with a first down have the clock stopped, 23 seconds to play.
Homer Causey doing a great job. Bad snap, ball gets away, but look at him. He takes his time, knew he had time to pick it up, grabs it, scrambles back to his right, and he kept his eyes downfield. He kept looking for someone, and then Carpenter broke wide open. Got him the football. That's a huge play.
That's a good call, Butch. And sometimes it's easier said than done. You have those big guys tracking you down, but you can see him with his head up here, still looking to make something out of this play.
He didn't panic. You know, he kept his wits about him, scrambled around, located his receivers, and made the big play. A big, big completion there. And that's the kind of lift you'd like to get going into the locker room. If they could put some points on the board now, which they took over with a minute and some odd seconds left. So this would be a great way to finish the first half.
There's a man having a good game himself, and Steve Carpenter came in with 15 catches, at least 4 in the first half, and he's put the Tigers at the edge of field goal range. Right now, they'd be at about a 41-yard kick, which is where Medina knocked one through in the other direction in the first quarter.
More of that veteran leadership, though, from Causey. Situation, the whole thing could have blown up on that, but he kept his wits about him. Was very calm, picked up the ball, and just kept looking downfield to make a play. And now, because of that, they have a chance for at least 3, maybe more.
Here's my question for you, Butch. Are you getting greedy here, trying to get to the end zone, or are you setting up a better field goal try?
In this game, I would trust my quarterback. He's a veteran quarterback. I know he's been out for a little bit, but I would put the ball in his hands and trust him to deliver it.
There's your answer, looking for the deep ball. And we'll see a flag inside the 5-yard line. The pass was intended for Larry Clark III. It was Alexander playing the receiver and not the football.
Big play. Sometimes if you try to push the situation, you can make something happen. He had a man open. He couldn't do much about it, so they came up with the pass interference.
Now,
call.
In the college pass game, you do not have to turn your head.
On the defense.
But you can't run into the wide receiver.
Yeah, you can't run him over.
First down.
You can't run him over, and that's exactly what happened right there. But by that defensive back, it's number 13. It's Gavin Alexander. That's a good play because that was a touchdown.
That's right.
Had he not made that play. So that was a really good play on his part with 17 seconds to go in this first half.
It's a mark-off, not spot of the foul penalty, so the football is at the 11 rather than the 5-yard line. So with time running down, 17 seconds to go. Maybe two or three plays for TSU if they want to take a shot to the end zone. Malik Cross has already caught one today. He has six on the season. He's lined up as the slot to the right, the third receiver at the bottom of your screen. Causey will find Porter. Porter needs to try and get out of bounds. He will at the 10, maybe a gain of one or two on the play, but a wise play by Porter to get out with 9 seconds to go.
It was a gain of one or two, but he did a heck of a job getting out of bounds because that was the main thing. He wanted to stop that clock. He knew exactly what he was doing, kind of set that defender up to where he could make it to the boundary and stepping out of bounds to kill the clock.
One more crack at the end zone for TSU before they would have to bring on Medina for an extra point try. Entertaining first half to say the least, but the Tigers hoping they aren't done just yet. Causey back, has to get rid of this football. Our time's going to run out.
Oh, no.
This is trouble. Now they only have one shot, that for a score, and the ball's up for grabs, and the Tigers nearly had it. Cross got his fingers on it, but the play took so much time, the half is over.
That time, I think he lost track of the clock and where they were on the football field and what they were working on at the time. A great play. Causey, right there, he probably should have just thrown it away at that point and go ahead and kick the field goal.
So two plays that took so long, the Tigers did not get a shot to kick a field goal, and they'll go into the break down 9 instead of maybe 6.
He fires it into a crowd, and Cross had a shot at it in the end zone, got his hands on it, just couldn't pull it in. But that was a situation where Causey might have not been aware of what was going on as far as with the clock, because he scrambled around and probably should have thrown it away immediately.
So a couple of big long plays put the Tigers on the doorstep. You'll see TSU waiting for the Golden Lions to head to their locker room first. We'll have an extended halftime here at homecoming, so no hurry to get into the locker room, but there's probably a few messages that Coach Asbury and his staff want to deliver, because while there have been some positives, Butch, yeah, disappointing to be down 9 at the break.
Well, it is to this team who haven't won a SWAC game. They're 0-5 in SWAC play. But I think one of the things, we talked about it earlier, they did make the defensive adjustments last week. You know, it didn't look like it in the score, but they shut out Alcorn in the second half. And I'm looking for these guys to do the same thing today, to go into that locker room right now, to make the adjustments, to find out what Arkansas Pine Bluff is doing and what we can do to kind of shut them down a little bit. Coach Asbury was talking to Causey right there, and I think one of the things he was probably talking to him about was, you know, good move. I know you were trying to make something happen, but in that situation, there was just like 7 seconds to go left in the game. How about just, if it's not there, throw it away. Let's kick the field goal and go in the locker room.
You think about the Colt McCoy play in the Big 12 championship for Texas a couple of years ago, facing Nebraska up at Jerry World, where the ball goes out of bounds with 1 second to go. Had it been zero, of course, they do not win. They don't go to the national championship game. But you try and make a play as a quarterback, but that internal clock, you can't hit the snooze. You got to react. Causey did not. And I think we're about ready to send things downstairs. Nick Strong has the coach, Daryl Asbury.
Hey, I'm here with head coach on the sidelines. Coach, Homer Causey in that first half, looking pretty good there. Is he giving you what you want?
Yes, he is. We just need to decision making. I think he's moving the ball well, coming off of a setback early in the season. Just a second ago, I just told him going into the locker room 9 seconds ago, you can't scramble around. You got to save yourself some time, kick a field goal, call timeout, and get the 3 points if nothing else is there.
Coach, on the defensive side of the ball, what are you going to tell your team at the half?
We're going to make some adjustments. They won't continue to run that same play. We just need to make a few adjustments within the D-line and the linebacker set, and we'll be fine.
Coach, good luck in the second half.
Thank you.
All right. Hey, thanks a lot for watching TSU Sports Network. You're watching TSU football here on TSU Sports Network. We'll be right back.
define the fabric of a team. It's not selfish. It's not boastful. It's about many, sewn together to reach one common goal. But in order to win, you must learn to work together.
To the Bud Light Halftime Show. Again, I'm Brett Dolan with Butch Alcindor. 26-17. Tigers trailed the Golden Lions of Arkansas Pine Bluff at the break. It was 10-10 after one quarter, Butch, an even more entertaining second quarter, but Arkansas Pine Bluff has come to play today.
They have come to play, and they've come out and they've done a lot of things. They've spread the field out so they could run the football. Hadley had a fantastic first half, but for a while they were starting to look like whichever offense had the football last would be the team that may end up winning this thing, because both teams are showing off their powerful offenses. And of course, Homer Kazi going back into the starting lineup for the Tigers today. He's played a fine first half. He had a little hiccup there right at the end of the first half where they didn't get the field goal, but overall you got to like what he's doing out there. I mean, he's throwing the football extremely well.
Yeah, he's had a strong first half. It was the pick in which the ball, he got hit as he threw the football, and then the play where he couldn't get the touchdown of the end zone. That really may be plays I'm sure the Tigers will talk about at the half and wish they could have found ways to get at least a field goal in those
situations. That's one of the things we want to talk about, because last week they lost, you know, big at Alcorn State, but in the second half they shut out Alcorn. They didn't get any points at all. So hopefully they've showed the ability to make those adjustments, and they can make those adjustments today and come in the second half and slow this offense by the Golden Lions, because they've been moving the ball up and down the field.
They have been impressive indeed. Let's take a look at some of the halftime highlights here from BBVA Compass Stadium.
And there's Mr. Hadley. They've done a really good job from an offensive standpoint of coming out and spreading the field to where most of TSU guys, they got two wide receivers on one side, two receivers on the other side, and the middle of the field is wide open. Hadley's so quick. And this was a key return. LeTevin Wilcox got down the sideline, and for a minute there, it looked like he might go, but then the kicker slowed him down just enough.
But Homer Causey's made a couple of plays today, Butch, where he's really had a scramble, and this time he found Davion Porter, and watch the footwork here.
This was an incredible play. Porter cuts it back all the way across the field, right there in for the touchdown. Plummer came back to escort him in, but there was nobody out in front. That was a great play for Homer Causey.
Just about
Porter.
The time, though, it seems like the Tigers have some momentum. Back come the Golden Lions, and this was the big tight end, C.J. Branch, rumbling into the end zone.
He's a big tight end, made the catch, and he was wide open. And then here's more of Porter. Porter, like you said, he is very, very steady for this team. Seems to make it happen. A big catch by Larry Clark. That was a huge first down. That was third and three, and they got it. And then the touchdown to Cross in traffic. Malik Cross brings it in.
Six touchdowns this year for Malik Cross. Just missed another one at the end of the half. Tigers have been chasing Benjamin Anderson. That time a nice play, but he is really tough to try and locate.
Well, he's lived up to the hype. He really has lived up to the hype today. He's come in here. He's done it with his feet. He's done it with his arms. And then this guy, Hadley, just banging away into the end zone for the touchdown. This was a great play. Causey picks it up, keeps his head, stays calm, scrambles out to the right, and completes the pass for a huge first down and set the Tigers up for close enough for a score.
Tigers have had a couple of wow plays, but this was the one nearing the end of the half where the clock is winding down. It's touchdown, do or die. Here is so close for Cross, but when that fell to the turf, there was no chance for a field goal.
I think if Homer Causey had that one back again, especially after he scrambled out, he would have thrown it away immediately, so they would have had a chance to get the field goal.
Final thought, we heard from Coach Asbury there with Nick, and he said we have to make a couple of changes. They can't keep running that same play. That's all he said. We know what that same play is. It's Hanley getting up the middle for 10, 15, 20-yard jumps.
They got to do something to make an adjustment there to get some people in the middle.
Tigers trailed at the half 26-17 here on homecoming. They'll hope for a big third quarter, get back in this game, and find a way to get win number six. 26-17. TSU trailing Arkansas Pine Bluff here at the intermission. And we'll join our halftime proceedings already in progress.
Cooper, Miss Homecoming, 2014. And now, the moment we've all been waiting for, please join me in saluting your Miss Texas Southern University 2014-2015, LaShonda Barlow. LaShonda Barlow, Miss Texas Southern University 2014-2015, is a senior majoring in health administration from Temple, Texas. She plans to become a neonatal health administrator. Her campus involvement includes serving as a member of the Student Government Association, University Program Council, and as a proud member of Alpha Kappa Alpha Sorority, Incorporated. During her reign, LaShonda's platform, ROBOTS, which stands for Reaching Out Beyond Our Tone, involves assisting people with disabilities on campus and in the surrounding community by ensuring that they are heard and have a voice. LaShonda is escorted by Philip Turner, an electronic engineering technology major. Miss Texas Southern University 2014-2015, Miss LaShonda Barlow and her escort, Philip Turner. And now, honoring Miss Texas Southern University is TSU's 11th president, Dr. John M. Rudley, accompanied by his lovely wife, Dr. Dosha Rudley. Let's give another TSU round of applause for Miss TSU 2014-2015, LaShonda Barlow, her escort, Philip Turner, Miss Homecoming, Crystal Cooper, and our distinguished president and his wife, Dr. and Mrs. John M. Rudley. Ladies and gentlemen, the 2014-2015 Royal Court, we are one. We give special thanks to our many sponsors for their support and generous contributions. And last but not least, to our alumni, faculty, staff, students, and friends, we thank you for your continued support and always making Texas Southern Homecoming a success. Texas Southern University, happy homecoming.
Mic check. At Phillip Field, we've got the baddest. Oh, and I mean the baddest drum majors around. Mr. Malcolm, Touch the Sky, Bledsoe, and Mr. Lorente, American Dream, Obi. Both raining from the windy city of Chicago, Illinois. And on this evening, we have our junior drum major, Little Mr. Gage Lowe. And they are the League of Extraordinary Gentlemen. Drum major, let's flip the switch and get this band on the field. Marching band fans, far and wide, do me a favor and let me hear you roar for the marvelous, the magnificent marching musical machine of the mid-south. The band will open up to 9th fanfare. The band will kick off tonight's show with a series of precision movements to After Seven's Heat of the Moment. Have of the Golden Lion, keepers of the pride, often imitated but never duplicated. The University of Arkansas at Pine Bluff, the place where you want to be. At this time, I'd like to introduce to you the one and only, the mesmerizing 24-karat Golden Silk. The Golden Silks are sponsored by Miss Allison Jackson. They are ladies of style and grace, poise and sophistication. They're sweet and classy as can be, ladies and gentlemen, the UAPB Golden Girls. Dancing to Cheryl Lynn's Got to Be Real. The Golden Girls are sponsored by Dr. Ann Williams. Taking this party back. Taking this party back old school. This is when I dip, you dip by the Two Live Two. I put my hand up on your hip. When I dip, you dip, we dip. Hey! It's an old school party. And what's an old school party without a slow jam? This is Silks for Reek Me. That's right, Emporia. Show them how we freak it. At this time, I'd like to introduce to you the Boldacious Baby Got Bat Girls. If you're old school and it still makes a lot, let me hear you say yeah. Or if you're new school and it's Nicki Minaj, let me hear you say turn up. Give it up for the Bodacious Baby Got Bat Girls. Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, at this time, we ask that everyone would please stand to your feet and give a roaring applause for all breast cancer survivors, caregivers, and supporters. Let me hear you make some noise as we continue the race for the cure. Isn't she lovely? The band has been under the direction of Mr. John R. Graham. Assistant band director, Daryl Evans, Harold Fuster, Jerome Hudson, and James Hood. I am your announcer, Clarence Stokes, and entertaining you has been our pleasure. Thank you and have a good evening. And don't forget, we'll see you in the fifth quarter. Mic check. All right. It's homecoming. How many of y'all ready for homecoming? Hey, Ocean. I said, set your homecoming out. Mic check, mic check, mic check. Ladies and gentlemen, are you ready to set your homecoming off? T.S. Please direct your attention to the end zone where the world famous Ocean of Soul will take the field, led by Ocean alumni, including instrumentalists and always classy Major X from the 2010s, the 2000s, and beyond. And leading them out, Action Jackson, all the way back from the 80s. Taking the field to the traditional Ocean Beach, as they did in 1969, it's the Ocean, the ninth wonder of the world, created by the maestro, Benjamin J. Butler, the one and only Ocean. And you know who's the most exciting band on the planet. Just say what? Ocean. Now lean way back and say, in recognition of Breast Cancer Awareness Month, the Ocean says there's a ribbon in the sky for the love of the one who can cure breast cancer and the ills of all mankind.
Ocean Soul, Ben Butler, we'll never let you go. in honor of this year's homecoming theme. This one's for you, First Lady Dosha Rudley. Say it loud, say it proud. We are one. You on your feet, cause we are one.
Hear it for the alumni motion of the ocean. And don't forget, once a motion, always a motion.
And now, observe as with classic style, the ocean takes less than a minute to cover more than a mile. We're all wound up and about to let go. It's time to pull you into this ocean's flow. It's not the size of the wave that makes you drown, but the motion of the ocean when it hits your town. If you think we're gonna turn down, don't even trip. It's time for Rip! Breakdown! All right, it's about time to shake what your mama gave you. New school tigers will recognize Anaconda, but you old school tigers know it's all about Baby's Got Back. Unless you got buds, hun, let's have an old school dance party. Right side, show me what you got. Uh-oh. Come on, left side. Little bit of running man. Uh-oh. Hammer time. Left side, hit him with that club.
Now let me see your tootsie roll. All right, everybody get this thing together. I said 1, 2, 3, 4. Shake, 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 shake. Down to the floor with your ow. Uh-oh, old school coming back. They're gonna show you how to really do the Bluff now. Come on, get up. Come on, let's have a hand for old school ocean. What? Come on, sing it with me. What? Do the smutty now. Oh, yeah. Ain't nothing wrong if you want to have homecoming all night long. Happy homecoming and enjoy this family reunion. Congratulations, all TSU Tigers, young and old, on your 87th year of excellence in achievement. Happy homecoming and enjoy this family reunion.
Oh, come on! That's a hole!
I hate watching with Ramsey. All he does is yell. They can't hear you, Ramsey. But every time he's come over this year, we've won. And he always brings Bud Light. Little dog won't come out from under the couch. But we're winning. I love you, Ramsey.
Bud Light, for the fans who do whatever it takes.
The environment is my passion. Every day I live for the outdoors and all of its challenges. That's why I enlisted in the Coast Guard. Now, I serve to protect the environment and defend my country. It's like I was born for this.
Were you born ready for a greater challenge? Find out at GoCoastGuard.com.
Hello, I'm Alan Helfman, Vice President of River Oaks Chrysler Jeep and Dodge. This is my friend and customer, Miss Georgia Provost. River Oaks Chrysler Jeep and Dodge has the all-new, totally redesigned Chrysler 300. River Oaks Chrysler Jeep and Dodge has the all-new, totally redesigned Jeep Grand Cherokee.
Ellen is the only car dealer I will ever buy a car from.
Come see us at Kirby in the Southwest Freeway.
Halftime festivities have taken place here at BBVA Compass Stadium in downtown Houston. What a sunshine-shadows contrast here inside. 26-17 Arkansas Pine Bluff with the lead over the TSU Tigers. Butch Alcindor and Brett Dolan with you. And Butch, you look at some of these halftime stats, you almost do a double take.
You know, not only have we saw an outstanding first half, then a fantastic halftime, but then what you're talking about is just eye-popping when you look at Brian Hanley. I mean, that's incredible. 14 carries for 180 yards and two touchdowns. Now, I've never been any good at math, but that equals out to 12.8 a carry. I mean, that is fantastic.
Even then, they passed for 146. The total yards, these teams have combined for 621 yards. Arkansas Pine Bluff has the advantage in that category with 354. And this is an offense that they've scored points in recent weeks, but it's really yet to all click. I think in that first half, they saw signs that it has.
You can bet that this is what the Tigers spent most of their halftime doing. They weren't worried about watching the band. They were in there trying to stop Mr. Handley because that has been incredible. It's only the second time this year that the quarterback has not been the leading rusher for that team. So I'm sure TSU went in at halftime and tried to find what kind of defensive adjustments can we make to slow this guy down. So, you know, make him beat us with the pass at this point, but we have to do something. You can't let the guy run for 180 yards in the first half.
No, and the disappointing part for TSU, they were close to getting a touchdown at the end of the half. The time ran out. They weren't able to kick a field goal, and now they have to kick off and give the football back to the Golden Lions to start the third quarter.
First half, so exciting. TSU punted one time for 54 yards. The Golden Lions did not punt at all in the entire first half.
And the Golden Lions will get the football. Marvante King from the 10. As a head of steam, Marvante King up near the 40. Outstanding field position for Arkansas Pine Bluff to start our third quarter. Golden Lions 1-5 on the year, 0-4 in conference play. TSU trying to get that sixth win, trying to win their fourth in conference play. There's a replay of the opening kickoff here in our third quarter. So Hanley, who was not listed on the depth chart at running back, was behind Aaron Legron, Michael Wilson, but he has been one of the stars of this game. Will line up to the right of the talented senior quarterback, Benjamin Anderson. Anderson goes up top and his pass is behind his tight end, C.J. Branch.
That gave you an idea right there, Brent, of what they're going to come out and try to do in the second half. Hanley, you know, attracted so much attention. If you fake the ball to him, something should be open in the secondary, and that's what they were trying to do there. And the pass is incomplete.
Anderson, 9 of 13 of the first half. That pass incomplete. Wilcox there on the coverage. And there's Anderson racing up to midfield. He took a tremendous shot. He should have the first down. Well, he got popped up high by Latevin Wilcox again.
But you see what's going on. Again, it's that zone read. He pulls it out. It's a good keep because everybody went with Hanley. They have to at this point. So he picks up a nice gain on the play. It was a good read by Anderson, the quarterback, and he turned it into a first down.
To me, that looked dangerously close to maybe a targeting penalty there.
It was close. He got hit pretty high.
He did, and Anderson was being thrown down, so that target moves, and that's the tough part about being a defender. Sticks move again, though, for the Golden Lions. A check down underneath, and the pass into the hands of Portia, and then it's incomplete. It was picked up by Johnson. He was hoping to take it back the other way. Michael Holmes.
Yeah, Michael Holmes right there on the play, and the Tigers had good coverage on that. They wanted him to check it down, and they got up there in a hurry, and he did not make the catch. He checks it down right there, and then starts to run with it just a little too quick. It's just an incomplete pass.
Well, the Tigers would love to get a turnover of some sort. Anderson, though, does not commit many. Remember last week, 533 yards of total offense. First-team all-conference player as a freshman, as a sophomore. Even last year, a huge year. Right now, no place to go.
I think
it was
Conley again. Yes. What a game he's having so far. Jarius Moore also down in there. Tigers are getting tough on defense. Look at this play. Big shot.
Seen number 18 everywhere today. He's third on this team in tackles, but Butch, it feels like we've called his name over and over defensively. In fact, in that first half, he was involved in several.
Well, he and Moore have definitely stepped up a lot on this Tigers defense, and now we got a big third down coming up. So this would be huge to put this drive to bed right here and end it.
Pine Bluff 3 of 5 on third downs so far today. There's a marker, and Anderson will be hogtied and thrown out of bounds. Thrown out by Derek Lyles. We'll see what the marker's all about.
How you doing?
So it'll be fourth down. So the penalty was declined, so the Tigers defense able to get off the field.
But now you can see the big difference right there. They had pressure. Check out Derek Lyles and company. They put the heat on Anderson that time. He scrambles around, didn't really have a chance to look downfield, and that was huge. And guess what? They're going to punt for the first time today. Great defensive stop by the TSU Tigers.
Malik Cross is back at about the 10. Dylan Niehiser kicking again for the first time today. Averages about 37 a boot. A directional kick that has a chance to be down inside the 5, and it'll trickle over the goal line into the end zone. So the Tigers get off the field on defense. They'll get the football back with 13-14 to play here in our third quarter. And now A-Rocket Movers presents Do You Know TSU? Tonight's question is, how many athletic teams does TSU have? We'll give you some time to think about it. Check back later on in the game.
We'll let you think about it. I've already kind of peeked at the answer there, but we have about to have a guest on here. I'm sure he knows the answer to it. Dr. John Rutley is going to join us here in a little bit.
Davion Porter lined up to the right of Homer Causey. Causey very accurate in the first half, completes his first pass. And it's Steve Carpenter again. David White on the stop, but Carpenter now with his fifth catch already.
Over the last 3 weeks, this young man has really stepped up and become a big part of the offense. Carpenter is really, he's just built on every week, and he's had more and more success, and you can see the confidence growing.
Been a favorite target of Causey, now 14 of 19 through the year. He'll let Davion Porter try and pick a hole. Boy, so quick and shifty. Another nice cutback at the 40. Even then, he stays on his feet. He was at the marker. Then he lost about a half a yard. Might be a little bit shy, but another tremendous gain by the young Davion Porter.
I like to see that. You know, he could carry the ball a little more, but what a great run. A good block right there up front to spring him. And then Porter makes a nice move there, cuts inside, and that's a big gain for a first down for the Tigers. That offensive line doing a really good job on the running plays.
Even on second and very short, the Tigers will spread it out. Three receivers to the right. Davion Porter with a head of steam. He'll have the first down and more. Nice spin back at midfield. And then he got leveled. Hit pretty good by Dave White and Kevin Rucker. But the sticks move again for TSU.
If you look at the right side there and the hole just opened up, great blocking up front. Porter hits the hole, and it's another Tigers first down. And, hey, that's what you wear them out. Just keep pumping it to him right there. If it's open, just keep going to Porter. He's making a great job.
So the Tigers in a Golden Lions territory. Remember, they got down in field goal range, weren't able to score at the end of the first half, and had a kickoff to start the third quarter. So now trying to get back in this one. There's another pass complete to Carpenter, Gentrell Woodard.
I like what Causey did there. He was looking downfield. He wanted something bigger. It wasn't there, so he checked it down to Carpenter. Good play for positive yards to keep the ball moving up the field.
Woodard, the Oakland, California native there on the stop. It'll be second down, six to go. So the Tigers, when they've had their best offensive drives today, it's been a nice balance of run and pass. Here's Kendall Denson in the game, and he will fight forward near the 40s. A little bit shy of a first down by a couple of yards. Willie Duncan again on the stop, the leading tackler on this team, the middle linebacker for the Golden Lions defense. This was a defense, Butch. Let's put this into perspective. Coming into this game, Arkansas Pine Bluff allowing 43 points a game. That is dead last in the SWAC.
But they weren't playing like that today, and that's you kind of got to play the team that shows up. And the one that showed up today has been playing pretty good defense so far. But the Tigers have come out of the locker room, and you can tell they've made a few adjustments.
Little option here on third and short. Get into the hands of Davion Porter. He'll gain the first down and just push the pile all the way to the 30-yard line, carrying Kyle Walker and company. But that's not a good sign. Slow to get up is Porter. He took quite a shot here at the end.
Porter around the left side, cuts it inside. He's hit by a host of Golden Lions right there. But, again, a really good push by that offensive line. I mean, the Tigers are averaging 5-6 yards a clip right now.
So the Tigers on this long, sustained drive after getting the first punt return of this game. And they're 30 yards away from finding the end zone again. Petipa into the game. Petipa will get the carry. Tries to step out of a tackle, and he can't do so. Several Golden Lions there, including Willie Duncan. Also looked like Caleb Eli, defensive end, was involved, and Kyle Walker.
Jimmy just wasn't fast enough to hit that hole. It opened for just a second there, and he almost got there, just didn't quite make it. So he's pulled down for like a loss of one, so the Tigers will come out second and 11.
Just like that, Porter back in. Homer Causey looking to the sideline for a play. Three receivers, you see them to the left, the wide side of this football field. Here comes the rush. Causey has to get rid of the football. There's Porter. Porter with a head of steam. Cuts back at the 15. Porter on his feet to the 6.
great play call right there. You know, that had screen written on it from the very beginning, and they never saw it. It looked like a jailbreak, but the Tigers were setting up the screen the whole time. Causey does a great job getting the ball to Porter, and then he does the rest. He cuts it back across the field, and for a second there, when he cut it to the outside, I thought he might be able to score, but now he's down for a first and goal at about the six-yard line.
Willie Duncan saved a touchdown, 25 yards on the play. First and goal from the six. The Tigers back under center with an I formation. It's Petipa as the tailback. And Petipa fighting near the goal line. He'll be a couple of yards shy. It'll be second and goal. Duncan one more time from his middle linebacking spot around the football.
But you couldn't get a better script than this coming out of the locker room. This is what Darryl Asbury was hoping for. You go in there, you get a good stop on defense, and you come out and you start a drive on offense, and now you're knocking on the door.
Now the Tigers trying to cash in. Second and goal. Petipa has not scored a touchdown yet this season, hoping to change that here. Fighting for the goal line. He's in. Touchdown.
And that was just a great extra effort by Jimmy Petipa, because he was stopped around the two-yard line, and he kept the legs moving. And as you see right there, he's hit, backed up at about the three, and he just kept driving the legs, and he's in for the touchdown. Big, big, big play. And way to cap off that drive. This drive does several things for you. One, it puts you on the scoreboard. You needed a score really bad. But it also sends a message to those guys that, hey, we can just drive it right at you and pile it right up your back, and that's what they did on that drive.
Good point, Butch. First to get off the field, forced the first punt this afternoon, a long, sustained drive, 80-yard march. Here's the
find the fabric of a team. It's not selfish. It's not boastful. It's about many, sewn together to reach one common goal. But in order to win, we must learn to work together.
Welcome back to BBVA Compass Stadium, where the Tigers have pulled to within 26-23 of Arkansas Pine Bluff. We now have a special guest joining Brett and I in the booth. Of course, Dr. John Rutley. He's the president of Texas Southern University. And I know, Dr. Rutley, you have to like what you're seeing going on with these guys coming out of the locker room.
I absolutely love it. We can see what you were talking about earlier. The coach said something to them, and they needed to go down and score. And more importantly, they needed to stop the team. That first series, so they did that on defense.
This is a big game, though, for the Tigers, because you're coming off of two straight 2-9 seasons. It's been a process. Charles McClellan talks all the time about we're building something over here. We're trying to get something. A win today, and they clinch that winning season.
Isn't that surprising? You know, I'm so happy for the team. You know, our APR ratings are up as well. Our football team has a 977 APR. So that shows you the total turnaround. We have kids who are going to graduate on time, and they play very well.
And they're doing good, and you can see things happening, and it's just got to make you, as part of the administration, feel that sense of pride.
Oh, I'm totally proud of the university in general, the athletes in particular, because of the NCAA problem we had about 5 years ago. we're just now coming out of those problems, and this is how you want to come out of those situations. You want to come out and be a lot better than you were before, and we are.
Now, let me ask you this. You were an athlete in college. You were a basketball player. You understand what happens when those competitive juices get flowing there. Tell me a little bit about what you like about this team.
Oh, their grit. They're really focused on their skills, and I think they're listening. They're coachable. They listen to their coaches, and I see that happening. They're young. They're going to develop. They're going to be even better next year.
Doctor, what does a winning football team do to the on-campus excitement, especially around homecoming?
Oh, you know, that's an easy question.
that's a layup for you, isn't it?
It really is. we have people from all over the country here, and a win would just kind of seal it. We had an event last night, and we had an event the night before that. We're going to have an event tomorrow night. So Ben Butler, our band director who created the Ocean of Soul, all the people were in town to celebrate him. So a win tonight is going to put the icing on the cake.
And I tell you what, this crowd is fantastic down here today. You've ordered up crowd. Our A-weather, but a great crowd.
I think it's the best crowd we've ever had.
It is, and you can see the defense responding to it. They just blocked a pass from Anderson, so it's contagious. Everybody is really kind of pumped up about it.
I'm ready to get out there and play, too. I think my eligibility is over, though.
it's a lot of fun, and to see these guys get to this point in the year, and like you said earlier, it's a process. We saw Coach Asbury getting around the team on the sideline, said, we're not done yet. You're back in the ball game, but let's push a little harder.
Yeah. Let's hope they push it on through and get a victory today.
You have so many things going on around campus now, but one of the things I know there's several guys on this team that have already graduated.
Isn't that wonderful?
That is fantastic.
Yeah, we have graduate students, and that's what you want. And that's what Charles has built with the compliance office. Mike Mileta doesn't get mentioned much, but the whole compliance area is responsible for kids graduating on time.
See if the Tigers dial up a blitz here on 3rd and 10. Forcing Anderson to work a little bit. They're going to get the sack.
And there's the pressure. Justin Wheat.
You think we might have a new Michael Strahan or two coming out of this program?
Justin Wheat has made a living of putting pressure on the quarterback, and there he was again. And time just ran out on Anderson. Big hit.
They look just like Michael Strahan out there. Is that Michael Strahan?
That wouldn't be too bad if you came up with another Michael Strahan. That'd be pretty cool. But there's so many positive things going on around here. And just to, like Brett was saying, when you have a football team playing well, it's just part of the equation. It gets everybody on campus fired up.
It really does. Winning is winning, and winning is contagious. So we hope to continue that tradition here.
Niehiser to punt for the second time in the game, second time in this quarter, and that ball shanked out of bounds. So the Tigers will have tremendous field position. So now down just three and a chance to see if they can tie it up or take the lead.
Dr. Rutley, you're bringing them good luck here. We got you in here. Yeah. Now they got the ball. They're back down in the Golden Lions territory there looking for another score.
Let's see if they can do what the coach is drawing up for them to do.
Now we had our A-Rocket Movers Do You Know TSU question. So with the doctor up here, see if he can answer. Tonight's question is, how many athletic teams does TSU have?
16.
We'll put you right on the spot. 14.
Oh, okay. I got two out of
maybe
about.
We're going to add a couple. I like it. Homer
you
sure
14? I thought it was 16.
I only read what they give me, so you might be right.
I think I'm right. I'm going to give that answer a C on your all's part.
Causey with a big pass to cross, but there is a flag down, so we'll see what the call is. But that what a beautiful play. What about Homer Causey coming back off of that knee injury? And you can tell that, you know, you guys not only missed his ability, but his leadership.
Yeah, we have. We've had a lot of injuries this year. I think the team in general is a year ahead of our expectations. So next year should be even a better year. You know, but this year is not bad.
You know, that's exciting when you are a year ahead because you start to see the progress, you start to see the results of all the hard work because make no mistake, whether it's spring practice, then you get into some of the summer work, and then you begin things in the fall. It takes a lot of commitment for these football players.
It does. A lot of time, a lot of commitment, and they stuck with it. Last year, what was our record last year? 2-9.
2-9.
And these kids are back, and that's what I love about them. They're playing their hearts out.
Davion Porter with a wide hole on the right side of the field. Davion Porter with a cutback. Down to the 20 and a huge gain, and the Tigers knocking on the door of the red zone one more time.
That's what you do after a penalty. You come back and you pick it up, and it's just a little draw play inside to Porter, and nobody touched him. I mean, he just turned on the Jets, and a huge gain for Davion Porter to set up the Tigers with a 1st and 10 at the 20. 21, looks like. But he's been a young man that's been steady, steady all season long.
Yes, yes he has.
It's a good look at Homer Causey again back in there today after missing the last couple of games. He showed some leadership on the field and on the sideline, and he's trying to take his team and put them in the end zone for the second time here in this third quarter. Low snap, but Causey able to pick it up. A couple of times today he has been scrambling for his life. Look at this C part. Causey trying to get to the boundary at the five. On his feet, and he's down for one.
And he's still not 100% yet.
No, he's not. You could tell, but yeah. Boy, what a great run and yeah. A good decision to keep it. But as he takes the football, you can see he's under pressure in the pocket, scrambles out. And at this point, I thought he might step out of bounds, and he was thinking about it, but no, I'm going to go ahead. I'm very close to that end zone, puts his head down, and just comes up a little short. But a good decision by Homer Causey.
Well, a couple of times in this third quarter, it's as if the Tigers are playing 11-on-8 with some of the wide holes they've opened up for Porter and Causey. And let's see if they can punch it in. Porter is the tailback with his I formation, double tight end formation. Davion Porter, the football. Davion Porter, the touchdown. And TSU is back in front. What a beginning to this third quarter.
Jamie Gleaton leading the way, the big offensive tackle there. And they just lined up all the big guys, and we're coming right at you. Stop us if you can. And they could not stop them. As we take a look, they go to the power formation. Davion Porter breaks the tackle, and it's that easy. How would you like to have what Coach Asbury said at halftime to bring to a staff meeting? Because whatever he told those guys, they're on fire coming out here in the second
half. You mean every Monday at my staff meeting at 9 o'clock? I'll use that.
That would be fantastic.
Rushing touchdown number 6 on the season for Porter, who also caught one today. The extra point from Medina is good. We'll step aside. 4:25 to play in the third quarter. TSU back in front. They lead the Golden Lions 31-26.
When we send an IBW electrician to your job site, I expect my electrical worker to be neat. I expect him to be professional. I expect him to be on time. I expect him to be productive. I expect him to do everything in his power or her power to ensure that employer is successful. Because what's going to get us more work is successful jobs.
The time is now to hire IBW electricians.
French's Chicken, or if it's been a while since your last visit, no place does chicken like French's. Our chicken is seasonized with our blend of Creole herbs and spices. Our side dishes include the tastiest greens and red beans and rice you'll ever put in your mouth. Try our new King Row rotisserie chicken at our Scott Street location. Come on by French's Chicken, where the taste lasts forever.
Well, from down 9 at the half to up 5 points, the Tigers. What a turnaround, Butch, here in this third quarter.
It's incredible. It's incredible. And now we were talking to Dr. Rutley, who's still with us, the TSU president. I can't imagine what Darryl Asbury said at the halftime, but it's something you need to can, because whatever he said touched these guys, because they came out. This is a different team in the second half.
Well, what I was saying earlier, they're coachable. You asked me what the differences were between their prior teams. This team is coachable.
This kick is going to bounce out of bounds at the 10.
You know, we talked about that a little bit in the first half, because one thing Coach Asbury said was they've made so much improvement this year, but he wants this team to learn how to close out games, how to close out big games.
Number 32.
Well, you know,
Texas Southern. Bible plays 30 yards from the kick. First down.
Constantly losing games, you can also learn how to constantly win games. And so winning is something you have to learn how to do, and closing out games is part of that, as my former experience as an athlete taught me. learn how to win. Once you learn how to win, you're always confident that you can win.
Well, they're taking a big step in that direction right now because they came out of the locker room on fire. Four plays, 59 yards, and all in a minute and 58 seconds for the touchdown. That was Homer Causey setting up the touchdown with a nice run, and then Davion Porter with the icing on that cake, and you couldn't ask for a better way to start the second half than the way that they started.
The talented quarterback Benjamin Anderson back out there for the Golden Lions. Little pitch to Hanley, and he has been contained and such a problem to bring down in the first half, and you know he was the topic of discussion at the half.
No doubt about it, and they've done a good job on both of them. And watch number 18 again. He didn't make the tackle, but he got there and slowed him up just enough for some of his friends to come along and put that guy down. And they've made some big adjustments. But while we have a chance, Dr. Rutley, before you leave, you're coming off of two straight 2-9 seasons. A lot of programs would be panicky. But you guys, I've talked to Charles about this, and you guys you know we have a plan. We're sticking to our plan, and you've seen some of the fruits of your labor kind of come to fruition.
Well, absolutely. We have a great athletic director. All of our sports teams are improving. And the coach as well, Darryl Asbury, he invested in us, and we invested in him. He's staying the course. So we're going to go with this team, the team of Rudley, McClellan, Asbury, our football team, our basketball team, Mike Davis, Janetta Mays Perry, the women's basketball coach. So we're going to stick with this team.
I was waiting for you to get to those basketball coaches. Those teams are so exciting to see them last year in the postseason and, of yes. course, get into the big tournament, the big dance.
Yes, yes.
That defense continues to come in then as Arthel Rye with a huge stop. And this looks like a different running back here in the second half. Hanley was nailed, and he just picked up nothing there. And now they're looking at second and 12.
So the Golden Lions approaching midfield. Anderson with that quick drop.
Oh, that's holding.
His pass was incomplete, intended for King.
They say you can call holding almost every play.
Well, it looked like he had a pretty good piece of him right there.
Right.
You could come back. I think that was Justin Weed again. Let's see. He was putting the heat on him. He stepped underneath and was just able to get the ball. But they're finding ways to get so much more pressure on Anderson here in the second half. I mean, they've taken him out of his comfort level a little bit.
So a four wide receiver formation here for the Golden Lions, and another chance to get off the field. Third down, 11 for this Tigers defense. Anderson with time to throw. His pass,
intercepted.
What a great play. Demetrius Johnson came up with the pick, his first of the year.
A great catch by a defensive player.
That was fantastic. Demetrius Johnson, great coverage. The receiver had a step on him, but he made up that distance very, very quickly. Anderson fires, and he reaches out, hauls it in. What a fantastic interception.
Oh, wow. And then he's carried off the field by his teammates. Somewhat, maybe he landed on top of the football. I'm not sure with that outstanding catch.
Well, hopefully he just got the wind knocked out of him.
Well, defensive player is not accustomed to getting tackled. So he'll be all right.
There he is. I'm watching him on the sidelines there. He looks like he's pretty good. Looks like he may have just had the wind knocked out of him. But what a fantastic play, and the Tigers go back on offense.
The Tigers needed to get that turnover indeed, so they've scored two touchdowns on their two drives here in the third quarter. Causey looking for more. A little pump fake to Malik Cross. He kept the football, then he lost it, but he was dropped.
It looks like initially he wanted to throw that wide receiver screen to Clark, and it wasn't there, and he made a smart move by pulling it down. And then he couldn't find anything else to do with it, so he just ran it right there. And that's a good, smart heads-up football play.
Drop by DeMarcus Berry, a man who's had 4.5 sacks this season. That not a sack, but no gain either, so second and 10. So the Tigers from down 9 to up 5 here in the third quarter. The final 2 minutes here in our third quarter. Primarily with the Tigers on the football field with the ball. So there's Davion Porter trying to string this play out. He'll get a couple of yards, but really nothing there. And no surprise, Willie Duncan, the middle linebacker, tracked him down again.
Good job there by Malik Cross to keep from coming back with the clip. You'll see he was coming back as Porter was coming his way. Cross was coming back into the picture, but then he decided not to hit him. That's a good decision there because you don't want a big penalty at this point as they go up to a key third down.
One thing we've seen the Tigers do, though, a few times today is pick up these third downs, and you think maybe third and 10, third and 11. not a high percentage play, but they've been able to move the sticks and stay in the field, and this is another challenge here with a buck 20 to play in the third. Causey with time to throw. Here's Fred Plummer. He's got the first down, then he gave it up. And Fred Plummer was beyond the sticks.
I think he still has it, but that wasn't a good decision right there because he had it when he initially made the catch. Yeah, I tell you what, Homer is throwing that ball today. I mean, he's really, I know he's still, the knee is not 100%, but he's getting a good push off, and he's really getting a lot of velocity on that ball. And Fred hauls it in right there and picks up the first down.
Dr. Rutley, it almost appears they're faster with these pink shoes and pink gloves. I don't know what it is. They just look, they look faster with this October breast cancer. Look, there's Porter. He always looks fast. Doesn't matter. Nice spin move. He's up at midfield and then planted hard after a gain of four in the play.
What has it been like on campus this week? Tell us a little bit about the excitement surrounding homecoming as we take a look at Porter just banging it inside right there.
Well, as we speak, there are about 2,000 people on campus who are tailgating. A wonderful evening. They've got pitch tents. They've got pavilions. They've got just people coming from all over the country. All the lawyers are in town. All the pharmacists are in town. And all the other academic colleges have their alumni in town. It's just a fantastic event on our campus right now. What I need to do is pick that 2,000 people up and bring them over here and drop them to the stadium.
There you go. You had a parade this morning and a pep rally earlier this week?
Yes, we did. President's Gala was last night. And so... thank you.
Dr. Rutley, thank you very much for joining us in the booth. We appreciate it. Nice having you.
Always my pleasure, my friend.
You keep bringing the Tigers good luck.
Thank you.
Thanks so much.
Thank you.
We'll step aside. Fourth quarter on the way. Tigers lead by five.
Hello, I'm Alan Helfman, Vice President of River Oaks Chrysler Jeep and Dodge. This is my friend and customer, Miss Georgia Provost. River Oaks Chrysler Jeep and Dodge has the all-new, totally redesigned Chrysler 300. River Oaks Chrysler Jeep and Dodge has the all-new, totally redesigned Jeep Grand Cherokee.
Ellen is the only car dealer I will ever buy a car from.
Come see us at Kirby at the Southwest Freeway.
All he does is yell. They can't hear you, Ramsey. But every time he's come over this year, we've won. And he always brings Bud Light. Little dog won't come out from under the couch. But we're winning. I love you, Ramsey.
Bud Light, for the fans who do whatever it takes.
Coach Darrell Asbury sporting the pink. His team also sporting a five-point lead, and they'll have the football to begin this fourth quarter. Felt like the Tigers, Butch, were on the field almost the entire third. Couple of quick stops defensively, some long drives offensively.
And they were on the field the way you want to be, with the football. You want to have possession of the football. It's not good if you're trying to stop somebody, if they're running it down your throat. But they're in good shape right now.
Second and six. Kendall Denson out of the backfield. He lost the ball. He tried to get back on it. Kevin Rucker, spinning around the football most of the afternoon, was there to try to disrupt things. We'll see it again.
Now that would be the worst thing you could do right now, is to have a turnover on the play. As you can see, Denson hauls it in, and just when he goes to make a move, he drops the football.
Another test for the Tigers here on third down. It'll be third and call it 10. Have to reach the 44. Homer Causey steps up into the pocket, finds his man in stride, complete to Larry Clark III. He'll move the sticks again. Alexander the stop, but Butch, how many times on third and eight, third and nine, third and ten has Causey done this?
Big down, and he had Clark all the way on that, and he just threw a perfect strike to him, and a huge first down for the Tigers.
Pine Bluff had at least 13 men on the field. Davion Porter's loose. Davion Porter with a cutback. Stays on his feet. My goodness, he can't be tackled. He's still going to have his forward progress stopped at about the 5. Kyle Walker again on the stop. There were two defenders for the Lions who weren't even off the field, and Davion Porter says, don't worry about it. I've got it.
They might have had 13, but they probably needed 15 or 16 because Davion Porter just weaves his way through that secondary before he's finally just held up right there until some help could arrive. But a huge, huge run for Davion Porter, and now it's turning into a big game for him because he's up to 134 yards on 14 carries.
And that was before that last carry. So he's probably well up over 150, starting to make his impact. He scored a touchdown on the ground, also had a scoring reception. He stepped out, and right now Kendall Denson in. Darrell Asbury wants a timeout. The play clock was winding down. Did he get the play off? Oh, that hurts.
Delay of game, offense, number 4. 5-yard penalty, first down.
So the first and goal, now the Tigers backed up 5 yards after the walk-off.
And that hurts, you know, and they overcame the last penalty on the last drive, and that's what you're going to have to do again today. You don't want to do anything to beat yourself in this situation, and they've really done a good job with the penalties today. I mean, they've really kind of reduced some of the penalties, and that's always a big help. You're looking at some of those big offensive linemen in there, though. I mean, Marvin Holly, of course, he's the senior from Houston Madison. I mean, he's pretty big for a center, but he's been doing a job leading the charge for that offensive line.
Tigers have scored 2 touchdowns in 2 drives here in this third quarter, trying to go for the hat trick, and there's another marker down as Causey steps out. So the Tigers may be shooting themselves in the foot here, going backwards with a couple of mistakes once they got to the doorstep. Penalty on Fred Plummer.
And that's going to be a key holding call right there. And he's trying to help out his quarterback. I understand what he's doing there, but you really, really have to be careful. You're right in front of the official. He's got a good chunk of the jersey right there. It's kind of hard to miss that one.
Easy call. So instead of first and goal from the 5, it's first and goal from the 18. Heading in the wrong direction. So Porter's back in. Let's see if he gets a carry. Screen set up for Porter. They'll go up top instead, and the pass incomplete. And there's a marker down in the area of pass interference. Larry Clark III, the intended target.
And that's going to be all good. That's going to make all your ills go away right there. Eddie Kelly with the call, but what a huge, huge break for the Tigers.
It's like Turner, the guilty party, number 48.
There's no flag for defensive pass interference. Ooh. Second down.
Well, the officials give it, and then they take it away.
Yes.
That's tough. Let's see.
That's a good play. Yeah. I like that pickup. It doesn't help the Tigers out, but that's just the defender beating the receiver to the football.
He was going for the football. Good, aggressive play.
Really, the hold. Well, that will happen, and that was the big penalty of the 2, but the delay of game can't happen in that situation. Beginning this drive, of course, at least when it got first and goal from the 5.
Well, even if you had to settle for a field goal, you want to get some points on this drive.
Causey can't take a sack, however. Pass to the boundary, caught by Plummer. He'll step out of bounds, and there's another marker down, this one at the 9, and it looks like it may be offensive pass interference. At least that was what the back official motioned to our referee.
Pass interference, offense, number 16, 15-yard penalty, second down.
Steve Carpenter flagged for the infraction. That is now 3 penalties for the Tigers, and now they're almost at a field goal range.
Let's take a look at that. He said on well, we couldn't see it there. There was the pass to Plummer. You know, you can't have a flag on every play. So, I mean, you probably could, but if you're an official, you shouldn't. So, you know, let's let these guys play football now.
Second and goal from the 34. And the Tigers want to recalibrate, and they'll burn a timeout. So much has gone right in this game, and especially this fourth or second half, but not in this fourth quarter.
Not in the fourth quarter, and you don't have enough of a cushion at this point to let that happen right now. I mean, you really want to keep pouring it on and making that deficit bigger and bigger at this point, and that's where the penalties can really hurt you and wipe you out.
You can catch every home game live via our web stream at tsuball.com/live. tsuball.com, your number one source for Tiger football.
I tell you, one of the most impressive things about TSU the last couple of weeks, and even though they lost last week, is, and I mentioned that before, but it's very impressive to be able to go in the locker room and make those type of adjustments that they have today. Because they were the Golden Lions were having their way with the Tigers' defense. And so far in the second half, and we're in the fourth quarter now, they have made adjustments. The running yards are not there anymore, and they're doing a good job
on
Anderson.
Now you don't want to see that man, Homer Causey, maybe try and get greedy, put a ball up for grabs and get a pick when they were so close to maybe another touchdown. But he can't take a sack either. Homer Causey back to the 40. It's going to be third and goal from the 41-yard line. And Causey twisted like a pretzel before he hit the turf.
That's a tough play. Golden Lions coming with some pressure inside. One guy got through, and that's a heck of a play right there by number 54.
DeMarcus Berry, five and a half sacks now in the season, so that's kind of his specialty.
It's a good tackle by Berry because Causey almost slipped away.
You almost need to get 15, 20 yards back to be in field goal range. Third and 41. Davion Porter will try and get a few back on the ground. He will. But even now, with the football's marked at the 35, you're looking in excess of a 51-yard field goal. Caleb Eli, the stop defensively from his end position.
Well, and this is Coach Asbury is going to have a tough decision to make as Davion Porter takes it in there and picks up a nice gain there. We'll see. He'll probably go for it. I mean, this is a long field goal. It's going to be 50-plus at this point. So we'll see what he decides to do. But I wouldn't be surprised if he went for it. The ball is on the 35. That'd be a pretty long field goal.
Just no margin for error here. It has to be the end zone or nothing. So there'll be three receivers to the left. See if Causey has enough time in the pocket to set up and maybe look for the deep ball down the left sideline. Arkansas Pine Bluff's going to call a timeout.
You know, you're stuck in no man's land right there because it, I guess the field goal would be 52, which is probably within Medina's range. But you can't punt because if you punt, it's going to go through the end zone. It'd be very difficult to down a punt inside your 10-yard line. We'll see if the timeout, though, doesn't give Coach Asbury a chance to change his mind.
It's true. Homer Causey comes over to the sideline. You can catch the TSU football replay in HD after every home game on Tuesdays at noon, only on CSN Houston, the home of Tiger football. Brett Dolden, Butch Alcidor with you from BBVA Compass Stadium on homecoming. Tigers trailed at the half by a score of 26-17. They've done all the scoring here in the second half, but this is a drive in which they got down to the 5-yard line, first and goal, and they've gone backwards since, and now they will indeed punt. Corey Carter, who leads the nation in punting average, will have to do more of a pooch here.
Well, he did it.
Football stopped at the 5, and he was motioning as if, hey, the ball was surrounded. Let it keep bouncing.
Outstanding punt.
We'll step aside, 10:37 to play. The Golden Lions will have the football when you come back.
Define the fabric of a team. It's not selfish. It's not boastful. It's about many, zoned together to reach one common goal. But in order to win, you must learn to work together.
man's a winner. Maybe not this year. Monty Coleman, the former Washington Redskin head coach of Arkansas Pine Bluff. His team gets the football back, and they'll gain a couple of yards. And, Butch, you think about Monty Coleman. Here's a guy that was drafted by the Redskins in 1979. He played 16 years over the portion of three decades for the Redskins. Washington's had just three men play that long in their franchise history. Sammy Baugh, Darryl Green, played in four Super Bowls. He won three. And while the Redskins do not officially retire numbers, some can be withheld. Nobody has worn number 51 since. You talk about an archive of football knowledge for that man. Monty Coleman has it. And even though his team is trailing here in the fourth quarter, you got to believe he's happy with this position because they have not won a conference game this year.
They have not won a conference game, and for the most part, they haven't really been competitive. But they came in here and they played a very competitive first half. And but you mentioned some of those names, Sammy Baugh, some of the what great company
defense,
to be
number
in.
Six.
You can't beat that.
Penalty, first down.
You know, one of his good friends is Kenny Houston, NFL great in this city. I got to believe Kenny's probably here today as we're going to see that previous play. Anderson looking for some big yards up top. And the marker will advance the football, though even on that replay it was tough to see what transpired.
Well, you really don't want to give them anything at this point. And we've talked about it before, but you want them to earn everything and not get a big play like that.
Big yards again for Brian Hanley. Remember, he had 186 at the half. He'll fight forward up to about the 23 before LeKendry Conley was able to stop his progress. Hanley has been one of their forces offensively. Normally, it's been Anderson through the air. This is where maybe you start to fear the pass from Benjamin Anderson in the fourth quarter with Pine Bluff needing a touchdown to take the lead. But it is a second and short, second and three, so Hanley with the rush. He'll be right at the sticks, see if he's able to pick up enough to get the first down.
But, you know, you look at the stats, and Hanley had 3 yards in the third quarter. So that's to show you how tough the Tigers' defense has been coming out for the second half. He had 180 at the half and 3 yards in the third quarter.
Of course, the Tigers were able to get off the field a couple of times, some three and out. So now Anderson was able to pick up the first down. We'll see what he does here with four receivers, two to each side in this sequence. You're looking at a quarterback who began today seventh all-time in the SWAC in passing yards. The man he just surpassed, Doug Williams. Maybe you heard of him. There's another Redskin. That pass incomplete. What a hit on the corner by Trey Walker. We weren't sure if Walker was going to get back in this game. He did, and he delivered a blow.
And he looks pretty good on this one. Trey Walker being very aggressive, came up in a hurry, and that's how you play that. They try to hit that quick hitch to the wide receiver. You're the defensive back on that side. You get up and you stick him really quick, and you make him think about you because he's got to turn his back to you to make that catch. And you want him to know that you're going to come up there and smack him pretty good.
He rung the bell of Marvante King, so it's second and 10. Anderson to throw one more time. This time he will hit King. King will have the first down, and King is thrown down at the 40-yard line by Trey Walker. King lost his hat, and I believe Walker's down again.
Number 24 has to leave for helmet off.
And that's not Walker. It might be Trahan. Let's see if we can notice if it's number 9 at the end. It is. And, boy, that looked more like a concussion. He just got his head smashed. We may have to see that one more time. But he got some friendly fire, took a helmet to his grill that had him down on his knees.
Well, they were hustling over to the football. And when that happens, this can go on. Sometimes it is a friendly fire hit. And you can see him chasing King right there. And everybody's trying to get into the football, and then that's a big hit. But that's a good sign. He's sitting up, and he's shaking his head, and he's talking to people and running off on his own power. You know, this is a situation where if the Tigers had gotten 3 points on that last drive, you'd feel a lot more comfortable about this situation because that was an important opportunity.
Previous play one more time. You see all the Tigers converge.
Look like Connolly.
He's hitting everybody. Here comes Anderson. I mentioned he just passed Doug Williams on the all-time SWAC passing list. If he continues to move up the charts, he's going to leave his mark in this conference's history through the air. Has a chance right here. Drops into the breadbasket of Willie Young. He will take it to the house for the touchdown. A 60-yard score. The Golden Lions are back in front.
Boy, that was all Anderson on that one. He went back. He had time, but it was all in the pump fake. Watch him go back to pass. Pumps it. That's what got the defensive back. And then he lobs up a perfect pass right down the sidelines. Beautiful catch. And then a beautiful play beating Demetrius Johnson. Beautiful play by Willie Young.
Fourth receiving touchdown of the season for Willie Young to the house, 60 yards. And when the Tigers had a chance to go up big, they came up empty. And Arkansas Pine Bluff responded. That's a 95-yard drive for the touchdown.
And now they're going to go for two this time. But I mentioned before how the Tiger defensive backs were being aggressive. They picked up on that for the Golden Lions, and that's why Anderson went to that fake pump, pumped him on the sidelines, and the receiver broke behind him. And they got really a really nice touchdown on that play.
The timeout called before the two-point conversion. Hey, the next game, well, it'll be a good one. Grambling State. It'll be a battle of Tigers here next Saturday, a 5:30 kick right here at BBVA Compass Stadium. Tickets on sale now. Log on to tsuball.com today. I saw Grambling earlier this year. They played at Houston, and they got annihilated by the Cougars. I've never seen a team play any harder when they were getting their rear ends kicked. And it gave you an indication that maybe they would have the opportunity once they got into conference play to turn things around. And their start has been fantastic at 5-0.
And that's exactly what they've done. And that's why they're leading the West, and they're the team to beat right now. And to make that game as important as possible, the Tigers have to find a way to hang on today and get this victory.
So I'll give you a trivia question. Speaking of Grambling, I mentioned that Benjamin Anderson just passed Doug Williams all-time on the SWAC passing list. Do you know who number one is all-time in this conference, far beyond anybody else, with nearly 14,500 passing yards?
Wow.
It's a name that's very familiar around these parts, I'll tell you that. How about Steve McNair for Alcorn State?
Air McNair, if you think about that, it makes perfect sense. Steve McNair.
But this guy, Benjamin Anderson's had a heck of a career, and right now he's trying to convert a two-point conversion, but Pine Bluff can't get out of their own way.
Texas
timeout, first call by TSU.
Timeout.
We've seen back-to-back timeouts here on a two-point conversion, so both teams will be a bit limited in that category going down the stretch.
Well, it shows you how important they think these points are right here, that both the defense wants to make sure that they're in the right formations, and the offense wants to, you know, they want to make sure we're on the same page with what we're trying to do.
How big was that missed extra point earlier? Because otherwise you're looking at maybe a chance for a three-point lead as we take a look at our scoreboard. Speaking of Alcorn State, my goodness, 77 points.
Is that the basketball team or the football team? 77-48. And as you go down, you see Alabama State up 27-14 over Alabama A&M, that in the third quarter. And, of course, Heisman Northern over at Prairie View. He had a lot of injuries early in the year, and they've just not haven't rebounded from that at this point. So, but 77 is a lot of points.
That's a big day. Anderson, the only player right now ready to go. His entire team, the other 10, ready to join him. And because they missed an extra point early in the game, they're going for two here. And if the Tigers get off the field, they'd be in a spot where a field goal could win it. Hanley will carry, and he's not going to get there. Denied the end zone, stopped at about the one-yard line.
Connolly and company in there, a host of Tigers, and that was huge. That was such a big play in this game.
Lyles and Connolly, the two men at the bottom of the pile, and the Tigers get off the field even after that long drive for a score.
You know, he made the right read, Anderson did, giving the ball to Hanley, but that hose closed down so quickly.
We'll take a break, come back for the final 7:56. The Tigers down a point, they'll have the football right after this.
Percy Cruzo. If you haven't been to French's Chicken, or if it's been a while since your last visit, no place does chicken like French's. Our chicken is seasonized with our blend of Creole herbs and spices. Our side dishes include the tastiest greens and red beans and rice you'll ever put in your mouth. Try our new King Roll rotisserie.
rotisserie chicken at our Scott Street location. Come on by French's Chicken, where the taste lasts forever.
The environment is my passion. Every day I live for the outdoors and all of its challenges. That's why I enlisted in the Coast Guard. Now, I serve to protect the environment and defend my country. It's like I was born for this.
Were you born ready for a greater challenge? Find out at GoCoastGuard.com.
When we send an IBW electrician to your job site, I expect my electrical worker to be neat. I expect him to be professional. I expect him to be on time. I expect him to be productive. I expect him to do everything in his power or her power to ensure that employer is successful. Because what's going to get us more work is successful jobs.
The time is now to hire IBW electricians.
Darrell Asbury wants to win this homecoming game, wants to clinch a winning season today. His team was down 26-17 at the half. Butch, they ran off two straight scores to start the second half. Looked like it was going to be three. They weren't able to get that touchdown, and they just witnessed a 95-yard drive to put Pine Bluff back up.
And that left them in a kind of a bad position, because it would have been a lot more comfortable position had they gotten at least three, or if you want to go back to the three before the half. That was another one that slipped away, too. Because that was they would have had a good opportunity to get three right there. So, but now they're still in this, and all they need to do is put together another good drive.
LeTevin Wilcox from the three, hoping to provide a big return. He had one in excess of 50 yards earlier, kind of holding that football out to his side, and he's dropped at the 30. Let's go back and look at that previous scoring drive, though, for the Golden Lions. Remember, it was first and goal at the 5. They ended up having to punt the football, and then it was Benjamin Anderson and company that started to cause problems.
It was, and this drive was aided by penalties. So the Tigers had a couple of penalties, and that's always big. But it was 7 plays, 95 yards, and then that beautiful pass right there to Willie Young, who took it all the way in for the touchdown. Just a beautiful play, and now.
First down.
5-yard penalty tacked on to the end of the play, a penalty going against the Pine Bluff Lions, so a little more breathing room for Homer Causey and company. And Butch, evaluate what you've seen out of Homer Causey this afternoon.
I think he's looked fantastic. I mean, talking to Coach Asbury, they said he could have played last week, and I think they made a great decision by holding him back because it gave him more time to work with his receivers, more time to get in sync with them, and he's thrown the football really well today.
I thought we'd see a lot of Davion Porter. Right now it's Causey trying to make a play. Causey will gain maybe two or three before he is planted. And it was Kyle Walker there on the stop.
You know, as a quarterback, so much of your delivery depends on your legs. And so far today, he's been able to step up in that pocket and step through those passes. And he's had some velocity on his passes. So I think he looks pretty good.
The way Davion Porter's been running the football, maybe I was surprised he didn't touch it on first down. Now it'll be 2nd and 7. Play fake. Little bubble screen. Was that pass caught? No. And now it's going to be 3rd and long. Let's set things downstairs and locate Nick Strong.
What a game here at BBVA Compass Stadium. The fans are out loud on both sides, and both bands are giving it a big blow, but it was Homer Causey on the sideline leading his troops again. As I said earlier, he said he will not lose his homecoming game here at TSU, and you can look for him on this drive to be quite outstanding. We'll back up to you guys in the booth.
And Butch, we've seen a lot of 3rd and 9s, 3rd and 10s, and this is where Causey's really been at his best.
He's really taken advantage of this down so far. Now let's see if he can do it again.
Over the middle, pass complete. Larry Clark the third, he's got the first down and more. Progress stopped at the 48, courtesy of Woodard on the stop for the Golden Lions.
He has had a knack in the second half of converting these third downs. And that's just, you know, it's just tough on the defense when you do that, because now they got to reset and go for another three downs. So it's huge when you can come up there and convert on the third downs.
Shows you some poise and some confidence. Tigers on the march. Not a lot of time left in this game, the way the Tigers like to churn up yards and milk some of the minutes off the clock, magnifying the importance of finding points at the end of this drive. There's Porter, Davion Porter, looked left, cut right. He's into Golden Lions territory at a short gain. Willie Duncan the third wrapped him up.
See, I like this, though. I think this is good. You have time. There's 6 minutes and 14 seconds to go. You got time to run the ball some. You know, and Porter has not been stopped. He's been fantastic so far. So let's keep pumping Davion Porter and moving the ball down the field that way and, you know, continue to run the clock down. The ideal situation would be for you to go down and score with like 5 seconds left on the clock.
You just can't afford any negative plays or maybe big penalties. That's what killed that previous drive. There's Porter. And Duncan sniffed that play out, threw him down for a 5-yard loss. He has to have about 15 tackles today. He came in with 51 of the season. It's been a big day for the middle linebacker.
He's been all over the field, and that was another outstanding play right there. Of course, Causey kind of telegraphed this one. I mean, he was looking at Porter all the way on it, so they all made a beeline to Porter, but that was a big loss. Like you said, a loss of about five, so now the Tigers have another huge third down coming up.
There was one of your negative plays, so now it's third and even longer than before. Third and 14. Causey with time to throw initially. Now he's forced to run. Porter has to make a play in his own, and he is surrounded by five Golden Lions. He is shy by about 6 yards of a first down, and the Tigers may have to get the football back. Little flip, and then you can see all the white shirts around Porter, including Kyle Walker.
I think they're going to go for it.
How about this? Fourth and six, they're going to stay on the field.
Could be the play of the game right here.
Pine Bluff wants a timeout. They were locked up defensively. A little bit unsure. That's a case if TSU was really going to go for it. You have that tendency to want to snap the football when you see that confusion.
And they were very confused. They did not know where to line up, and that's why Coleman got the timeout really quickly there. But we'll see now. Last time we were in this situation, Coach Asbury changed his mind, and it ended up punting, and they got a fantastic punt down inside the 10. But now I'm sure he's going to weigh the clock, too. It's 4 minutes and 34 seconds to go in the game, so that's a big part of this. We'll see what he decides.
The team's beginning to run out of timeouts, so it will not be a final 2 or 3 minutes where one team can call two or three to stop the clock and get the football back. So the Tigers really would like to stay on the field here and convert.
And that's a good part of it, because if they would not have those timeouts to use on defense to where you might be able to get the football back.
One of the guys today has been targeted a lot is Steve Carpenter. Carpenter, the lone receiver to the left, the short side of the football field. Causey steps up, trying to keep this play alive. And the pass is complete to Fred Plummer, and he'll move the sticks.
You know, Causey's got to be the coolest guy in this stadium right now, because he's under all kinds of pressure. And he just did not panic. He kept looking. He wanted somebody open. He knew how far they had to go for the first down. He kept scrambling to keep the play alive. And look at Plummer working back to his quarterback with a big catch for the first down.
Alexander wasn't even in your picture until the very end. Now Porter trying to stretch this one outside. A little cutback at the 30. Stays on his feet. How about that run? First down play of 13 yards by Porter before Kyle Walker dropped the tailback for TSU.
But what a good call by Coach Asbury a couple of plays ago, going for that first down. You know, and like I said, a lot of it had to do with what you were talking about with the timeout situation and not being able to stop the clock. But he figured, let's put the game on the line now. They go for it, and Causey came up with the play.
Porter is limping, and he needs to come off the field. Because he jumped up, they may not get the benefit of an injury timeout. So Kendall Denson in as Porter gingerly heads off the field.
And that really hurts, because he's not only a threat to run the football, he's a threat coming out of the backfield. He's caught several passes today.
Causey will step up to throw. Denson will take the screen pass. Nifty move on his feet inside the 20, down to the 16. That's a gain of 7 on the play. Denson showed a little footwork off.
Fine play. Causey gives him the ball, and he gets it to him quick enough to where he has time to make a move. And he made a couple of nice moves and advanced the ball upfield. Good play.
Kevin Alexander brought him down with one arm, but a gain of 6, we'll call it. Denson just ran into the line and maybe gets a yard going forward, planted by Caleb Eli.
this may be a little bit of working the clock a little bit, because Chris Medina, we were talking to Dr. Rutley about this earlier when he was in the booth. He's just so proud of that kicking game, and Chris Medina has had an outstanding year so far this season. So they may be content at this point to just run a little bit off of that clock, and if they have to, put it in Chris's hands.
Nearing the 2.5 minute mark. Third down and 4. Can't take a sack here, this being in field goal range. There's a throw towards the end zone. It's caught. Touchdown. Larry Clark the third.
Great pass from Causey, and what a catch by Larry Clark. Clark had his man beat down the sideline, and it was just a matter of Causey to hit him in stride, and it was a beautiful play, and the Tigers get the touchdown.
Hey, take that field goal. How about going for 6 instead? What a throw. Perfect catch by Clark in the end zone.
You know, I've talked about it before, but you got to like the way Homer Causey is throwing the football today. Great route by Larry Clark. He had just enough separation, and Causey put it right on him.
Now, Butch, why not go for 2 here for the Tigers? Why kick and make this a 6-point game instead of a 7?
And now
there's a timeout, and they're wondering the same thing.
I think maybe he's listening to you, Brent.
There's a lot of assistance on the sideline, and I'm sure somebody's got that chart that says, hey, 5-point lead, we need to go for 2. But what a catch by that man, Larry Clark the third.
That was a huge play. It really was a huge, huge play. You know, Larry Clark had started the season off very quickly. He was having a good year. He had a slight injury, and now he's working his way back into shape.
3 touchdown drives here in the second half. Of course, the one time the Tigers didn't find the end zone, it looked like they were on the march and ready to find it again.
You know, this may be one of those situations that Coach Asbury was talking about. We have to learn how to close games. And they're getting a perfect opportunity here with 2 minutes and 31 seconds to go. They're up 5. You're right. You go for 2, you have a 7-point lead. You might as well, really.
Homer Causey, Butch, it's been the poise in the pocket for him today, and his ability to keep plays alive and convert big third down throws.
It's been huge. Coach Asbury did say something. You'll get a kick out of this. He was talking about how they were trying to start the game faster. Now, they've been getting out of the gate so slowly. They want to get off to a quicker start. He said, I'm changing the pregame meal. Instead of pasta and chicken, it's going to be either or. It's going to be pasta or chicken. So I told him, I said, I'm sure the offensive linemen aren't going to be too happy about that.
The Tigers, a little trickeration. Kendall Denson, did he get in? Boy, how about that? Stopped at about the 1-yard line. Who else? Willie Duncan, the third, dropped him. 2:31 to play. It remains a 5-point lead for TSU. This worth another look.
They tried to go wide. Denson coming around. He had a little crease, but what a play. Huge hit right there.
If he gets the boundary with a block from Malik Cross, he has it, and he just cut it up too soon.
You talked about Willie Duncan earlier, but this guy has had a nose for the football today, and what a big play.
We'll step aside, come back for the final. 2:31. The Tigers have the lead, up by 5 over the Golden Lions from Arkansas Pine Bluff.
It's the end of an era.
All the parties, the stories.
I'm gonna miss your smell.
You were my first.
What?
I knew it.
It's true.
Oh, man, I'm sorry I broke your leg.
I wrote a song. Sorry. Here we go.
Keep the good times going with the crisp, refreshing taste of Bud Light. Here we go.
Whoa. Check out this new couch.
Thank you.
Tigers 37, Golden Lions 32. Butch, what a game.
It is. What a fantastic game. And we saw the Golden Lions kind of take over the first half, and then you saw TSU come out of the locker room on fire and take over the second half. And we had the last home game go right down to the wire, but the Tigers managed to stay undefeated at home, and now we're looking at another one.
Patrick Roland looks like he'll get a crack from the four. Roland right up between the hashes and dropped it about the 25. Wagner there on the special teams stop, and let's go back and reflect on this last scoring drive for TSU.
What a great drive it was, too. They were behind. You had to go down and score. You had to get some type of score. 11 plays, 65 yards in 5 minutes and 25 seconds, and there's Davion Porter, who actually limped off the field. We don't know what his status is, but Causey did a great job of directing whoever was in there at the time as they go all the way down, and then the big play came, the pass to Larry Clark for the touchdown, a beautiful strike in the back of the end zone. Of course, the Tigers go for two. They do not make it, so that's why we have a 37-32 game right now.
And I think the Tigers had too many men on the field. We see more problems with this today for both teams than I have seen in football in a long time with 12, 13 men on the field.
Yeah, if somebody's not getting the message and they're not getting off at the right time. And it could be late substitutions. It's hard to tell. A lot of things could really attribute to that.
One thing that has to concern the Tigers is the senior quarterback Benjamin Anderson. Previous drive through the long touchdown bomb to Willie Young. Young is the receiver stretched out here to the left side, the short side of the football field. But a first and five, and it'll be Young targeted again. Same play, pump fake, touch and go, and he's got it! And he's going to go for the score. Same play, same receiver, and the same result, unfortunately, for TSU.
Wow. I mean, everything that could go wrong on that play went wrong. One, you didn't have any pressure at all on the quarterback, and that's because you want the ball out of his hands quickly. He just sat there and waited. He didn't really even pump. He just let his guy run straight past Demetrius Johnson all the way down the field for the touchdown for Willie Young. The other thing was they spread the defense out again, so you're not going to have any help over the top when you have receivers that spread, because they want to keep people in the middle to shut down the run. So boy, what a tough play there for the Tigers.
And now the Golden Lions will go for two. They have fell short on two different tries for extra points. The Tigers have done so once. There have been a lot of points left out here because of a missed field goal or a missed extra point earlier. There's 13 men on the field for the offense. Am I 2, 3?
That's been an issue today, and I bet you had someone who used to be on the extra point team that's not anymore, and they keep going out there.
This is my favorite. There's 13 men on the field, and they're all still standing there. Somebody's got to leave.
Well, we've seen just about everything today. 38-37, another big stop here for the Tigers. They really need a stop right now.
Going for two from the eight. Anderson, still a threat to throw, running out of room, and the Tigers defended that play perfectly.
Great job. That set the TSU Tigers up. Now, that's a great, great stop, because now you're 1 point down. You have 2 minutes to work with, and you have a really good field goal kicker.
So for a man earlier in Tyler Strickland who had not missed a PAT all season, he hit the upright on a PAT. They've been chasing that point all day, and they've left three out there. And now, because the difference is one, the Tigers in position where even with 2:15 left, they get in field goal range, they could win the game.
They can win the game, and they have an excellent kicker in Chris Medina, and they're hoping that they can get him at least a shot here. But Homer Causey's going to have to do it again. I mean, he's been excellent on third and fourth down as far as extending drives and getting them downfield, and he's going to have to continue to be patient. I know it's 2 minutes to go in the game, but he's going to have to do what he did the last time. Be patient and take what you get.
The one thing about, though, the Golden Lions, Butch, we've seen it back-to-back drives. They can hit for that quick strike. The Tigers are set up to be a little more methodical on offense, so there's still a lot of time left, but because they don't have their full complement of timeouts, they may have to play with just a little more urgency. So the key may be getting some decent field position here to start this drive.
Well, that was just an incredible touchdown. I mean, that was It was very quick and very shocking, but this game is not over by a long shot. 2 minutes and 15 seconds to go. So plenty of time for TSU to work the ball downfield.
Tyler Strickland has the football teed up at the 35. He wants a new ball. Apparently that one's no good. Kickers are like left-handed pitchers. They're a little bit particular sometimes.
Well, he should have changed balls before he missed that extra
point
is what he should have
That's
done.
That's right. It's not the carpenter. It's not the tool, it's the carpenter, right? Well, he's got it teed up again. The new, better football.
Maybe he's going to try to squib it or something. Nope.
High short kick that'll be taken by Wilcox from the 9. Trying to find a hole. And just nothing there. So the Tigers will begin from the 23 with 2:09 to play here in the fourth quarter.
They're going to be about 77 yards away from a touchdown. Here we go on the kickoff return. Letevin Wilcox, and there's just no place to go there. So this is the game, 2 minutes and 9 seconds to go.
Wilcox trying to give the Tigers decent field position. None to be had. So here comes Homer Causey and company. The junior out of Atlanta. It's two receivers each side. And right now, Davion Porter not in the game. So there's one weapon, maybe not fully healthy. And the pass well short of the intended target, which was
Larry Clark. It looked like he wasn't very sure of what Clark was doing on that play because and then finally he just threw it away. But this is a drive, and I'm sure Coach Asbury's happy to have Homer Causey back behind center for drives like this late in the ball game to have that experience.
I would look for Stephen Carpenter lined up to the left on maybe a slant. He's the lone wide receiver to that left. He's been coming up with big catches today. Guess what? There he is, Carpenter, not the slant. It was the curl out, makes the catch at the 31. Not good for a first down. Clock keeps rolling. Kevin Rucker has been near him most of the afternoon.
Causey fires a strike out there. It's going to bring up third and short, so the main thing is to get this first down right now.
A lot of time, though, has come off the clock since that previous play, 20-some seconds. And they'll try and run for it. Denson.
He didn't get
there. He did not reach it. And the Tigers short of timeouts. We'll see this clock continue to run inside a minute 30 to go. And now it's fourth down.
That's going to be fourth and short, but there's more confusion again on defense. A couple of guys went to come on the field, and they turned around and ran off again.
I think the crew asked for a measurement. Think about this, Butch. How rare is it to see a measurement in college football? Most of the time, they kind of give it the old eyeball test. I think because it's fourth down, maybe they might bring the sticks in for one of the few times you'll ever see in a game.
Yeah, no, I'm glad that they're doing this because he did get close to it. I don't think he got it. I think he came up short. But this way, TSU will know exactly what they need, and they may just – well, you'll know if Homer is behind center. I'd look for the quarterback sneak.
The big break here is they stop the clock, and they basically give the Tigers a timeout to talk about this while they measure to show you that they're that far.
Yeah.
Half a yard or less short.
I used to got to get upfield quicker than that. That's Denson. But you only need a couple of yards, and he goes sideways. He's got to turn that up a lot quicker and get his head down.
Davion Porter on the sideline. Has some ice on his foot on the bench.
Yeah, it looks like an ankle. He's got ice on his ankle there, so we know he's done because he's got his cleats off.
It's one less weapon on the field. And the Tigers need to extend this drive. Even if they get the first down, time will be of the essence.
They've been making plays on third and fourth down the entire game. Can they do it one more time? And look who's behind center this time. That's exactly what I was, looking at right there because it was only a foot. And you got a big quarterback like Homer Causey, and you had to have that first down. Now the clock becomes, it'll stop for the first down, but now it becomes really important.
Quite the surge. Here, as you see on the replay, boy, that's a scrum as the pile goes forward. But the Tigers need to have a play in mind. The clock will wind here, 1:13 and counting. Tigers still need about 35, 40 yards to get into field goal range, down a point. Too much time.
Yes.
We're going to be inside a minute before this football is snapped. Homer Causey slips out of a sack attempt. Pretty good cutback. Causey with some running room. Up near midfield into a slot. He's got the first down. Clock stopped. 47 seconds to play. His helmet came off. And good, now.
Good play by Homer, but what happens? Does he have to sit out?
Jamal Small's coming in. And Homer Causey has to exit.
Yeah, because his helmet came off, so he's going to have to go out for a play. But what a run. What a big, big-time play right there. Scrambled to get the first down, so he got the clock stopped, but then losing the helmet
There's
was huge.
There's no 10-second runoff. The first down, stop the clock.
So your tailback is on the sideline with an ice bag on his ankle. Your number one quarterback has to come off for a play. Jamal Small's been standing on the sideline for the better part of 3 hours, seeing his first action. It may be one of the most important snaps of the game. Got to get rid of the football. He can't take a sack. He'll fire one to the boundary. He's out of the tackle box. It's incomplete. 35 seconds to play.
Wow. He's lucky he got away with that one, because they could have hit him with grounding too. He got outside of that tackle box. But that's an interesting call, because this guy's been standing on the sidelines. You know, you don't know if you bet. That shows you the confidence they have in these quarterbacks.
The ball got past the line of scrimmage. There's no intentional ground. Second down.
And that was the key. Out of the pocket, but he has to get the ball back or beyond the line of scrimmage. Otherwise, it would have been grounding. Now you see Causey back in. But, Butch, what do you say? They've got to get at least 20 yards to have a 47-yard field goal try?
Yeah, I would think 20, 25 yards to put Chris in a very comfortable position here.
Need to get this football down the field. Causey, the man, maybe to try and do it. Causey waiting for somebody to make a play. There he is. It's Larry Clark again. He's down to the 20. Clock stopped on the first down.
The first down's going to stop the clock after, but Larry Clark had a chance to get out of bounds, and he chose not to. So can they get up there and spike it? Let's see.
The clock is rolling.
He could have gotten maybe not. What a good play by Causey. Buying time and finding Larry Clark. A great, great play right there.
They're not going to spike it. Too much time has come off the field.
There
now he'll spike it. At least 10 seconds went off the clock. Causey almost paralyzed by indecision for a second, and the Tigers are going to have to kick it here. Butch, this is the same thing that we finished at the end of the first half. The Tigers tried one more play and couldn't get the field goal off, so they will kick here.
And it's tough, but this is well within Medina's range. That's the good news for TSU. That was a great, great play by Causey. Talking about what we mentioned, how much he's kept his cool under pressure. He was scrambling around back there. He wanted the play to something to break open. He was looking for an ad-lib play, and he got it. And Chris Medina now with the game on the line.
37-yard field goal try. Medina 11 of 13 this year. Here's the kick, and it's blocked! And the Golden Lions were going to win this game.
You know, that ball never really got up. It was a really low kick. And the Tigers' undefeated streak at home comes to an end.
All kinds of celebration.
There is a
penalties.
Flag down, though.
Well, it's got to be on the celebration. Yeah. Tremendous surge. It looked like it was Dave White, maybe, who got up. Mark Lucien.
That's a celebration. Time Bluff. Half the distance to the goal. First down.
The accurate kicker, Medina, still has yet to leave the field. He just could not get that elevation needed. The ball was partially deflected.
Yeah, I didn't really get to see the snap, so I don't know if the snap was good, but something, he did not get the ball up at all, because the guy who ended up blocking it was almost like 6 yards, you know, away from the line of scrimmage. So when that happens, the ball doesn't really have any height on it at all. So I'm not sure. Next time we see it, we'll take a look and see how good was the snap on that play. But what a heartbreaking situation for the Tigers, because they played so well in the second half. They did so many good things.
Look at Darryl Asbury on the sideline, if we can get a shot, hunched over with both hands on his kneecap, almost as if it's hard to breathe right now.
Well, they played their hearts out here in the second half, and they put themselves in a hole at the end of the first half, but they really came out and played so well, and you had an excellent opportunity to close this one out.
Final play of the first half. The Tigers try for the touchdown. They can't get a field goal try. They go for the field goal with 10 seconds to play in the game. It's blocked, and the emotion on the face of Darrell Asbury as his team loses by a point.
Oh, it's a tough one because he knows that this is one that got away. You know, it's like the big one that got away because they came back and they played with a lot of determination in the second half and really put themselves in a position several times down the stretch. They put themselves in a position to where they could win the game.
Frustration indeed for the TSU Tigers. They will fall to 5-3 on the year, 3-3 in conference play with a tough Grambling team coming to town next week for a 5:30 kick here at BBVA Compass as the teams meet here at midfield. Butch, what a game, but the Tigers will be thinking about a lot of different plays in this one later on tonight, probably for the next week.
No doubt about it. They had their chances, and they know it, and these are the kind of games that are tough to get out of your mind, to stop reliving coulda, shoulda, woulda at that point.
For Butch Alsendorf and our entire crew, I'm Brett Dolan saying good afternoon from BBVA Compass Stadium. Homecoming is over. The Arkansas Pine Bluff Golden Lions come to town. They steal a 38-37 win over the TSU Tigers. So long, everyone.